224. When that failed, House Republicans unexpectedly found themselves facing a fast-approaching shutdown and no solution in sight. Hoping to secure a last-minute deal, the Senate then held a voice vote to approve a week-long funding bill. The House then quickly adopted that measure by a vote of 357 to 60.
You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans program. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. To learn more or to join the Fans program, visit fans.fppradio.com. That's fans.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports consumers in Colorado bought more than 17 tons of recreational cannabis during the first year of the state's new retail market, but sales of medicinal cannabis still outstripped that at almost 50 tons. In a national first, voters in Colorado and Washington state opted to legalize recreational cannabis used by adults in landmark twin ballots in 2012. The first retail stores opened in Colorado on January 1, 2014. States such as Oregon and Alaska that have now also voted to legalize recreational cannabis and others where lawmakers face proposals to do so are watching the Colorado's results closely. State tax officials say sales hit nearly $700 million last year, with medical cannabis accounting for $386 million and recreational cannabis bringing in $313 million. In its first annual report, the Colorado Department of Revenue's Cannabis Enforcement Division said 49.7 tons of medical cannabis were sold in 2014, while 17.5 tons were sold in the recreational market. It said 322 retail stores were licensed at the end of last year, up from about 206 months earlier, while 833 licenses were issued to retail businesses in general and 1,416 medical cannabis businesses were approved by the state. Supporters say voters have chosen to take the trade out of the hands of criminals, and a Quinnipiac University poll this week showed that 58% of Colorado residents support marijuana legalization, while only 38% are opposed. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Right now, it's looking like tonight's record $500 million Powerball drawing could be canceled, as embarrassed lottery officials have admitted they lost the balls. Douglas Bronstein, deputy director of the Multi-State Lottery Association, addressed the press moments ago. We have a quote. We know how important the balls are to a successful drawing. I saw them the other day, and I'm sure they'll turn up somewhere. Bronstein says it's usually marketing director Ben Callahan's job to keep an eye on the balls, but when reached for comment, Callahan said he just sits next to the balls. It's not his job to know where they are every second of every day. According to Bronstein, it's crucial they find the balls before tonight's drawing. Quote, we'd love to use different balls, but these ones have the numbers on them. Bronstein added that once they figure out where the balls are, they promise to keep them in some sort of case instead of just lying around the office. When we return, we'll meet some of the undeterred Powerball superfans who are camping out before the big drawing dressed as their favorite numbers.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. Welcome to the program, the live Saturday edition here. We'll take your calls about anything that you'd like to discuss. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We also have Skype. You can Skype in here at username lrn.fm. Derek J. Is with me here tonight. Hey, Derek.
Hey, Ian.
When's the last time you were on a Saturday show? It's been a while, I imagine.
Oh, yeah, months, if ever. I'm not certain I have or have been.
Normally, you are our Monday night co-host here on Free Talk Live, and you're known for doing all kinds of other things. We can focus on some more about you here in a little bit, but folks who want to learn more quickly can go to derekj.me.
That's right.
You are the star of Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree, which has been promoted quite a bit here on Free Talk Live over the years. So just kind of give listeners, in case they're new, because there's a bunch of people that listen on Saturday nights that don't hear the rest of the week's shows simply because we're on different radio stations tonight than during the rest of the week. So welcome aboard to you, the listener, and you can bring up whatever you want. But Derek J, you and I had a similar show prep tonight about these black sites.
Yes.
That have come out in the news here today. And I've got a piece here from The Guardian about this. This was news that came out this week. And of course, you know, if you want to get news reporting that's more accurate about what happens in the United States. You have to go outside of the United States to really get the best stories. Al Jazeera, Russia Today, The Guardian, BBC, all of these organizations, even though some of them are actually government-funded, do a better job in a lot of cases of reporting on what's happening in the United States than many U.S.-based media agencies. So this is coming from The Guardian, and it's about Chicago police detaining Americans at what are called black sites. The Chicago Police Department operates an off-the-books interrogation compound, rendering Americans unable to be found by a family by family members or attorneys while locked inside what lawyers say is the domestic equivalent of a CIA black site. Remember over the Bush years, hearing about the stories about the extraordinary rendition where they would take people that the U.S. government wanted to keep as, you know, their hostage and extract information from them, and then they would take them over to like Egypt or some other country, some other jurisdiction. The CIA agents would hand off the person who was to be abused and tortured to these other people from other countries and then have them do all the dirty work. That way the CIA agents or the government agents could claim that, well, it wasn't us. You know, we didn't torture anyone. Yeah, because these other guys did.
That always struck me as so despicable. Then again, it was happening in faraway countries, and I could just only imagine it being in underground dungeons or tents or something, and so no one really knew what was happening. But now it's... Are you saying this is happening here?
Something like that. The facility is a nondescript warehouse on Chicago's west side known as Homan Square, has long been the scene of secretive work by special police units. Interviews with local attorneys and one protester who spent the better part of a day shackled in Homan Square describe operations that deny access to basic constitutional rights.
And this is just a protester. That's what this person was charged with, like murder or
not terrorism. Correct.
Okay.
Alleged police practices, according to those familiar with the facility who spoke out to The Guardian after its investigation into Chicago police abuse, include the following: keeping arrestees out of official booking databases. That means that nobody knows you're there. Because if you haven't been booked, then no one can call. You know, you can't call the jail and say, hey, is Derek J. there? Did you arrest Derek J. Freeman today? You know, normally they tap in their little computer and see if they have a Derek J. Freeman there. Well, if you're in the black site, there's nobody that can look up the fact that you're there in the first place. So you are essentially disappeared. People that were held at this facility also encountered beatings by police, resulting in head wounds, shackling for prolonged periods, denying attorneys access to the secure facility, and holding people without legal counsel for between 12 and 24 hours, including people as young as 15. At least one man was found unresponsive in Homan Square's interview room and later pronounced dead. Brian Jacob Church, a protester known as one of the NATO Three, was held and questioned at Homan Square in 2012 following a police raid.
Wait a minute. In 2012? This has been going on for years?
Officers, yeah, I don't know when this thing started. But
that's crazy, because presumably these things would have to be staffed with, I don't know, lots of people. It looks like the building that they're showing in this picture at The Guardian is pretty big. It would require a staff of maybe 100 people or so. And you don't think any of them have spoken out or squealed saying, hey, I got hired for this job, and they were doing some creepy stuff in there.
I mean,
it takes, like, how do they do their investigative work if not calling up these people like, hey, do you work at this black site facility? Yeah. And they left this guy shackled. Oh, and you don't tell anyone? Like, who could work this job and think, yeah, this is normal?
I don't know what goes through their minds, Derek J. It's hard for us who believe in freedom and, you know, personal responsibility and liberty to actually put ourselves in the mindset of one of these government workers who, I don't know, maybe they've been told, look, this is a national security facility and you are sworn to secrecy, and you know, if you speak out about this, then we'll kill your family.
What?
I mean, I don't know.
There's nowhere where this is normal.
Well, it's definitely not normal. Hopefully this is not normal. Hopefully there aren't 50 of these things in, you know, all 50 states, and this report is just scratching the surface. Which, by the way, when I was reading this about Brian Jacob Church, the NATO Three, that rang a bell with me. Remember the story about these guys, Derek
J?
They actually, one of them was from Keene, New Hampshire, which is where we're from. They got arrested at the NATO summit, I guess, or something like that.
Yeah, for ostensible G8. Something.
Right, for ostensible bomb making, And so apparently one of these people was, let's see, going on here. He was held and questioned at this particular place. They restrained him for the better part of a day, denied him access to an attorney, and then finally sent him to a nearby police station.
But it just to be clear, it wasn't a bomb that these three were arrested with. As it mentioned earlier, they were protesters, and the police went to their homes and found empty beer bottles and considered that to be bomb-making materials.
Yeah,
if you recall.
I don't remember all the details on that, but I certainly will take your word for it. I know they ended up getting found guilty of some nonsense. Like, they didn't actually have the bombs, but the jury went ahead and found them guilty anyway.
Yeah, they had empty beer bottles at their house. Go figure. I mean, like most of America. Is that now somehow terroristic material?
Well, they were acquitted of the terrorism charges. This is according to RT's report from April of last year about the NATO 3. Acquitted of the terrorism charges, but were found guilty of two lesser mob action charges and one count each for possessing an incendiary device to commit arson. I don't know what the sentences were, but they're pretty lengthy, apparently. 5 to 8 years. So going on here with the story, Honan Square is definitely an unusual case, said Church. This is one of the NATO three. Mm-hmm. He said this to The Guardian, quote, "It brings to mind the interrogation facilities they use in the Middle East. The CIA calls them black sites. It's a domestic black site. When you go in, no one knows what's happened to you. The secretive warehouse is the latest example of Chicago police practices that echo the much criticized detention abuses of the U.S. war on terrorism. While those abuses impacted people overseas, Honan Square, said to house military-style vehicles, interrogation cells, and even a cage, trains its focus on Americans, most often poor, black, and brown."
Wait, and even a cage? What's the difference between a cell and a cage?
Well, you and I don't see any difference, but sometimes we get criticized because we use the term cage frequently to describe jail cells. Ultimately, they're just synonyms, but to people that are sort of...
So what? One is metal and has bars and the other is cement?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay.
Like, yeah, one in which you would place an animal as opposed to a human being, I guess, is sort of the way some people discriminate.
Like in Silence of the Lambs, like that kind of cage?
Yeah, maybe so.
All right.
The secretive warehouse here, unlike a precinct, no one taken to Honan Square is said to be booked. Witnesses, suspects, and other Chicagoans who end up inside do not appear to have a public searchable record entered into a database indicating where they are, as happens when someone's booked at a precinct. Lawyers and relatives insist there's no way of finding their whereabouts. Those lawyers who have attempted to gain access to Honan Square are most often turned away, even as their clients remain in custody inside. Chicago attorney Julie Bartmus says it's sort of an open secret among attorneys that regularly make police station visits. This place, if you can't find a client in the system, odds are they're there.
Wait a minute. So the attorneys know about this. Why aren't they speaking out about it?
Well,
clearly it's unconstitutional.
What can they do about it, though? 855-450-FREE, the toll-free number. And I don't know what their excuse for it is either. Maybe we'll learn a little bit more about it here. Your calls and thoughts are certainly welcome. How do you feel about the U.S. government, the Chicago government, operating a black site where people are being disappeared? It's Free Talk Live.
And my bag was saying, you cost me a lot of misery, and all total, $2,700 in doggy fees, and all it took was one container of Dynavite, 2 pounds, 3 ounces, and my dog has been cured. Abby's a 5-year-old silky terrier. She had, like, chicken pox on her belly, clusters of bumps on her back, and she was allergic to, like, 70-some-odd things. So the dermatologist, it was like, oh, yeah, just keep giving her needles every 10 days. But she's not clearing up. And then it came up on my radio, Dynavite.
DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
And I was like, oh, that's it. I give her the Dynavite after 5 weeks. And one morning, there was nothing there. And I'm like, oh, my God, she's all clear. There wasn't one blemish on her body. Her fur is beautiful. She is totally happy. She is a healthy, bump-free, pimple-free, shiny, silky. It turned our lives around. So thank you very much for Dynavite. I couldn't be happier. Dynavite's the bomb.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
DINOVITE.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenvention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special super early bird price of just $40 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $40 price only lasts through early March, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Do you drink coffee? Was the last cup of coffee you had really good? Free Talk Live has teamed up with BuzzBucks to bring you the best of the best coffee. Shade grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is for every 10 people that get their coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another microloan through Kiva. Get a free pound to try it out. A free pound of the best of the best coffee. Help others one cup at a time. coffee.freetalklive.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. It is the live Saturday edition. Of course, you can bring up whatever you'd like to discuss here. 855-450-FREE. Though we started the show out talking about these black sites, and there's a lot more to say here, including some individuals' experiences inside this black site. At least we know about one of them so far, and maybe there's more than one. I'm hoping there's not, but if there's one, there's a good chance that there's more than one. It's a secretive site in Chicago where people who've been arrested are essentially disappeared for what can be as long as 24 hours without anybody, even their attorney, being able to talk to them, among other constitutional rights violations. We can continue that discussion here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Also, I want to let you know about Cameron Hughes Wine. Now, Cameron Hughes is, he's not somebody who actually owns his own vineyard. He goes to the best vineyards and he purchases their excess inventory. So when one of these fancy wine, you know, wineries, when they make a batch of wine, they ultimately usually make more than they can actually sell through their regular channels. So they sell the extra wine to Cameron Hughes. He then puts his own label on that wine. So you don't know from which winery it came, but you do know that it's there are some of the best wines out there. It's just been essentially relabeled as Cameron Hughes wine. So therefore, you get wine that is normally $70 to $100 a bottle for, on average, about $15 from Cameron Hughes. And here's how you do it. You go to chwine.com, and then be sure to use code FTL, because that gets you free shipping. And that's the only way that you can get free shipping. And it's fairly expensive to ship wine. I mean, it's a heavy product. So, you know, and it's got to be well-packed and all that. free shipping when you use code FTL, like Free Talk Live, over at chwine.com. Just go there, click the microphone in the upper left-hand corner. That's when you enter FTL, and you'll save a bunch of money on shipping. And try out some of these wines. Derek J., you and I, we attended a wine tasting with Cameron Hughes Wine a couple weeks ago, and it was great.
Delicious.
And you were all dressed up. You had your suit on, and you recorded some video of it, and it seemed like you were really enjoying yourself.
Oh, yeah. It was terrific. And I wasn't sure. I knew about the labeling, and I wasn't sure if it would tell me what type of wine it was.
It did,
but they were all labeled the type of wine it was.
Yeah, you just don't know from which vineyard.
Really enjoyed them.
Come. So go again to chwine.com. Use code FTL to get the free shipping. Let's go to your calls. More about the black sites on the way here. We've got Straight Razor on the line in Dallas, Texas. You're on Free Talk Live.
Good evening, gentlemen. How are you doing, Derek?
Hey, good.
Hey.
Go ahead, sir.
So I don't know why this would be surprising to anyone. I was in the military also before I have my current job. And if you really want to know what's coming to your local police station, look at what the military's doing. Because, you know, obviously we've gotten lots of reports of, I guarantee you that torture is coming soon if it's not already here. Because it's the military is kind of like the testing grounds for, you know, social litigation. So it really didn't surprise me when I heard about the black site up there in Detroit.
Now, you're a law enforcement officer in Texas. Do you know of any black sites that are similar to the one we're talking about in Chicago?
If I did, I'm sure I wouldn't be a police officer anymore. Because I would have already been ringing the bell on that, because that's absolutely insane.
So what do you think about the police officers in Chicago? Did they know about this black site, or do you think they're reading it fresh off the newspaper like we are?
So I don't know how Chicago is set up. However, the larger a department becomes and the more people that are involved, the easier it is to find people to go along with the scheme. So,
I would think it'd be the opposite.
Chicago, absolutely not, because they get it's kind of like the federal government. You become a cog in the machine. So if there had been, instead of one large department, let's say, there were 16 smaller departments, it would have been a lot harder to recruit the personnel to just go along with what the machine was doing.
I have to take your word for it. I mean, you do say that you are a law enforcement officer, but so why is it easier to recruit? Simply because they have a larger pool of people that want those jobs?
You have a larger pool of people, and then you have a much more extended process to get to the top of the chain of the command.
Mm-hmm.
So,
which filters out the good guys, right? So, like, if
exactly.
It's a longer process, then only the bad apples are going to rise to the top.
I see.
Exactly. So, if it had been a bunch of smaller departments, and I could just walk up to the chief and say, "Hey, chief, that you know, something is messed up here. You sent me to another department to pull an extra duty, and this is what they had me doing." As long as you have a decent chief, which I try and stay around. Then things will get done. But if there's only one chief and he's a bad apple, then you've got, you know, hundreds of people and they've only got the one bad apple to report to. Now, that being said, this is completely inexcusable. I think any officer that stepped foot in there should be charged with as many counts as possible for kidnapping, holding against someone's will. There's just a plethora of charges that should be thrown on them.
Well, now, of course, the Chicago police are going to say that it's all legal and by the book. We'll get to their quote here in a moment. But Straight Razor, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. Let's talk to we've got David in San Francisco. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Derek J. Hello, David.
Hey, honey.
Go ahead.
Hey, you know, I'm glad you raised that issue about that. Was it Homan Square? How do you spell that?
It is Homan, Homan Square in Chicago.
Oh, it's not a D. Okay, good. Yeah, I noticed there were a number of stories. I even see USA Today is in there. So, yeah, apparently it is getting a little coverage. You know, I was going to say, when you... I don't know if you noticed, but a couple of days ago, the state auditor from the state of Missouri committed suicide.
Yeah, we talked about that last night.
Right. And if you look at his final audits, there are a number of really creepy audits that are very similar to this Homan Square. For example, the Department of Corrections in Missouri, it looks like they stole maybe as much as $8 million just in the last 3 years. And one of them that caught my eye right away was they're handing out cash, cash payments to the executioners, and found that none of them, check out the auditor's office for the state of Missouri and look at the final few of them, because they were stealing money from, the prisoners build furniture and whatnot. Mm-hmm. So they stole over $7 million just from that fund.
Well, I consider all of that to be dishonest money, right? Like, you're putting prisoners to work for essentially free. In a lot of cases, sometimes they give them a pittance. But when I was in jail, I was essentially slave labor for the county. And Derek Jay, I think you did some of that work as well.
Yeah, so. I was forced to work. However, they wouldn't say it was forced because you always had the option to go into solitary confinement. Yeah.
Thanks, David, for the call tonight.
Well,
in fact, sometimes when you get sentenced, they'll actually sentence you to what they call hard labor. That's part of the actual sentence. And frequently you'll hear that it's like part of the sentence, just a couple of the words the judge will spit out at the very end of sentencing is, you're sentenced to 6 months of hard labor. 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. More on the Chicago black site, or is there more than one? 855-450-FREE, you can share your thoughts. You okay with this? It's Free Talk Live.
By now, you may have heard a bit about Bitcoins, but did you know Bitcoins are now over an $8.5 billion market? And did you know that over 65,000 businesses now accept Bitcoins? Listen, if you're already earning Bitcoins or trying to make money in the Bitcoin market, you've got to know BidBit.co. Why? Because BidBit.co is where you can easily receive Bitcoin by selling and auctioning off your own personal items or promote business products and services for Bitcoins. You heard right. Whether personal or business, you can now buy, sell, and auction your product and services quickly, easily, and securely for Bitcoin at BidBit.co, the first and only marketplace website to offer BidBit escrow, a proprietary technology which gives buyers and sellers security and peace of mind because all transactions are protected. Start today. It's free to join, free to post, free to auction, and free to bid at BidBit.co. Buy, sell, bid, or auction everything Bitcoin. That's www.bidbit.co, BidBit.co.
Good morning. Later this afternoon, I will be engaging in an extramarital affair. Of course, I will wish that I had never made the horrible mistake I'm about to spend several hours making. But sadly, I'm currently too blinded by greed and lust to care about or consider the consequences of my actions. The liaison I will be taking part in shortly with two poor deaf teenage runaways is in direct opposition to the values you elected me to uphold. I also wish to apologize to my wife, Linda, to my two beautiful children, Allison and Christopher. It hurts me more than you will ever know that this scandal will impact your life so terribly. I can only pray that the revelations you will soon hear concerning my fetishes, physical flexibility, and penis will not scar you to the point of dementia. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to get to the hotel immediately, so I will not be taking questions. Thank you.
This is the Onion News Network.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross may be spending the rest of his life in prison. His family is planning to appeal his conviction, but they need your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Ross needs your help now more than ever. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is Free Talk Live. We're talking about the revelation that was revealed this week by The Guardian, theguardian.com, black site being operated by the Chicago Police Department, an off-the-books interrogation compound, as it has been described. We can talk more about it because we've just kind of barely scratched the surface on this. Plus, Derek J., you have been looking over some testimonials, if you will, by, I don't know if that's the right word, but people's experiences. Testimonial usually is something positive, but I guess it doesn't have to be. People's experiences regarding what happened to them in this black site. We'll continue that discussion here. Also, want to let you know how to get some coffee for free. An entire pound of some of the best coffee out there can be shipped to you at only the shipping costs. So you're not actually paying for the pound of coffee, you're just paying the shipping costs over at coffee.freetalklive.com. And it's great coffee, 100% organic, top 1% grade Arabica, and shade-grown coffee from BuzzBox. Now, once you get started with coffee.freetalklive.com, you then become a part of their auto-ship program. You can customize how often you receive coffee and how much coffee you receive at any given time. And you can, of course, select from a variety of flavors at coffee.freetalklive.com. And you can feel extra good because a portion of the profits from each pound is going toward microloans that are helping people around the world make a better life for themselves. So you get great coffee. Your first pound is free. Just pay the shipping cost over at coffee.freetalklive.com. Back to the initial story here from The Guardian. They have a lot of coverage about this particular topic. The Chicago black site, which is located at a place called Homan Square, and people have been going to this site for a number of years. According to the story at The Guardian, a Chicago civil rights attorney, Flint Taylor, said Homan Square represented a routinization of a notorious practice in local police work that violates the Fifth and Sixth Amendments of the Constitution. He said, quote, "This Honan Square revelation seems to me to be an institutionalization of the practice that dates back for more than 40 years. And that practice is violating a suspect or witness's rights to a lawyer and to not be physically or otherwise coerced into giving a statement." Unquote. Much remains hidden about Homan Square. The Chicago Police Department did not respond to The Guardian's questions about the facility, but after The Guardian published this story, the department provided a statement insisting, without specifics, that there is nothing untoward taking place at what it calls the sensitive location, home to undercover units.
Well, just the fact that the lawyers and police seem to know about this place tells me... So, you know, first of all, something's going wrong here that they can't speak out about. I want to elaborate with one other article by The Guardian, which interviewed some of the victims there.
Please.
Three people, Brock Terry, Corey Wright, and DeAndre Hutchardson, were held between 2006 and 2011. So this has been going on.
And they were held for a string of murders, right?
At least.
Killings?
No.
Bombings?
No, in fact, Brock Terry was caught with 5 pounds of cannabis. He ended up being shackled to, and this is why I would say this, the lawyer mentioned, the Fifth and Sixth Amendments? I would say it violates the Eighth as well, the prevention against cruel and unusual punishment.
Okay.
So this Brock Terry guy, who was caught with 5 pounds of cannabis, ended up being shackled to, quote, little circular things behind the bench, arms spread open, being fed only twice in 3 days.
Oh, gosh.
And it elaborates saying, and so like with his arms spread open, like, you know, Jesus on a
shackled
cross.
Shackled to a bench, yeah.
The Chicago police are known for turning up the temperature in the facility to extremely high temperatures and then depriving victims of water while they are tied up, arms extended.
That's interesting because it's kind of the reverse of what is typical in jails. A lot of jails are very, very cold to the point of it's very, very uncomfortable, you know, that level of cold. So you're talking about the reverse where they're actually making it too hot for people.
And it might dehydrate a person. Too cold, you know, it's easier for some people to fall asleep. Too hot, they're just sitting there possibly sweating to death.
Well, the reason ostensibly for the too cold, the claim is that will stop infections and things like that from spreading, or viruses or germs. I'm not a doctor, but so there's some sort of medical reason for that. That's their excuse for it. I don't think it's a good one, but so if it's warm, then that's certainly going to encourage that sort of thing.
A quote from this man, I sat there in place for 3 days with no calls, no talking to anybody. They called police stations, presumably his friends and family, called police stations. I'm not there. I'm not there, is what he said regarding his location and whereabouts. So it's like really concerning. The straight razor, who's a police officer, says, oh, torture's next, because just look at the military and whatever the military does, the police will do soon after. It looks like it's already happening, yeah.
Chicago Police Department abides by all laws, they say, rules and guidelines pertaining to any interviews of suspects or witnesses at Homan Square or any other CPD facility. If lawyers have a client detained at Homan Square, just like any other facility, they're allowed to speak and visit with them. It houses CPD's evidence recovered property section where the public is able to claim inventoried property, the statement said, something numerous attorneys and one Homan Square arrestee have denied. Quote, this is more from their statement. There are always records of anyone who's arrested by CPD, and this is not any different at Honan Square.
Yeah, but there might be records, but they're not official records. If you write someone's name down on an index card, that's not really the same thing as putting it into the system database.
Yeah, if you can't access the record from the outside, if no one outside of Honan Square knows who's there, or Homan Square knows who's there, then what good is the record? The Chicago police statement did not address how long an arrest or how long into an arrest or detention those records are generated. So, you know, will they generate the record after you've been there for a day or two?
Yeah, and if nobody knows you're there, how can your lawyer get a hold of you? So it seems like that is a lie. I mean, them saying, oh, people can see their lawyer is like, yeah, maybe once in a while some victim of theirs has seen a lawyer if there's some high-powered attorney already or something. But it's like this guy who's arrested for pot, you really think he wasn't sitting in there for days without seeing a lawyer?
Department spokesperson did not respond to a detailed request for clarification. And when a Guardian reporter arrived at the warehouse in question on Friday, a man at the gatehouse outside refused any entrance and would not answer any questions. Quote, this is a secure facility. You're not even supposed to be standing here, said the man who refused to give his name. Now,
what?
When you encounter a situation with government bureaucrats who refuse to identify themselves, look out, because you are in a very dangerous situation at that point. These guys are supposed to have some level of transparency, some level of accountability, to the point where at least you should know what the name is of the bureaucrat that is ordering you around or demanding things of you or telling you you can't be somewhere, so you can then, you know, check the rules that they're supposed to be following and see if they're breaking those rules, and if so, be able to know who the hell they are.
And also determine whether or not they actually are a government agent. I mean, the danger here for me is that there would be individuals claiming to be government agents. If there's this precedent that you don't have to know who government agents are and they can just boss you around, well, that just tells sociopaths and psychopaths the right thing to do is to dress up as an authority figure and start ordering people around, and no one will question it.
Sure, because how can you know to whom would you go to ask, And how would you describe the person who you were dealing with in the first place? Hopefully they got video of this. A former Chicago police superintendent and more recently a retired detective, both of whom have been inside Homan Square in the last few years in a post-police capacity, said the department did not operate out of the warehouse until the late 1990s. So this appears to have been going on for over a decade. But in detailing episodes involving their clients over the past several years, lawyers described mad scrambles that led to the closed doors of Homan Square, a place most had never heard of previously. The facility was even unknown to Rob Warden, the founder of Northwestern University's Law School Center on Wrongful Convictions, until The Guardian informed him of the allegations of clients who vanish into inherently coercive police custody.
Wait, clients who vanish? That means they have lawyers, and then the lawyers aren't able to get in touch with them and speak with them. Isn't that exactly in contradiction with what the facility just claimed?
Yes, absolutely it is. Anthony Hill, criminal defense attorney, says, quote, they just disappear until they show up at a district for charging or are just released back out into the street.
Whoops.
855-450-FREE. There's more to say about this black site. You are welcome to share your thoughts here. Does this make you feel good? Are you feeling like you're protected and served? Feeling safe now that you know that the police have a secretive site where they can just take people and then let them out if they feel like it, when they feel like it? 855-450-FREE. Share your thoughts.
When the leading antihistamine and Nasacort go nose to nose, Nasacort wins, stopping more of the chemical responses that can cause your nasal allergy symptoms. And when you stop more causes, you get 24-hour relief from sneezing, an itchy runny nose, even congestion. It's prescription-strength medicine available over-the-counter. Nasacort Allergy 24-Hour. Stops more of what makes you miserable. Use as directed.
Khalid lives in Gaza. He makes his living as a taxi driver. The engine in his old beater blew up. Now, he makes good money driving people in his cab, but he couldn't afford the $1,300 for a new engine. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the engine, and he's back on the road. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. coffee.freetalklive.com.
This alert just came in. This special announcement is for business owners and leaders of organizations who've been waiting for the right time to build. General Steel has made it impossible to wait any longer with rock-bottom prices that could save you thousands. That's right, General Steel, America's leader in pre-engineered structures, is offering buildings at prices you will never see again. Don't miss these prices. A 50 by 100 for $35,000. You heard right. That's 5,000 square feet for $35,000. Manufacturers, if you need a larger building, try a 100 by 100 commercial building for $129,000. You can't afford to rent with these prices. Imagine a 70 by 100-foot church building for under $69,000. With the economy improving and interest rates still at historic lows, you can't afford to wait. So call 866-91-STEEL. Lock in your price now. Call 866-91-STEEL. That's 866-917-8335.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
How many lawyers does it take to change a light bulb? None. They'd rather keep their clients in the dark. There are too many lawyer jokes to count. However, there are some lawyers with more noble intentions. At the Institute for Justice, we bring the light to our clients. We are a nonprofit public interest law firm with clear values and principles. At IJ, we fight for those whose most basic rights are denied by the government. Visit our website today at ij.org.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, the live Saturday edition here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We also have Skype. You can Skype in to us at username lrn.fm. You will generally sound better if you can do Skype, so please do send a contact request over to lrn.fm. We will approve it as soon as we see it, and then after that, it'll be easy for you to call us from that point forward. Let's, in fact, go to Skype. We can talk more about the black site. There's a lot more to say, people's experiences, both the people that were imprisoned there without any kind of record for an indeterminate period of time, and the attorneys who were denied access. That's all on the way. Shocking allegations or revelations. I mean, this thing exists. Obviously, the Chicago Police Department doesn't want to agree that all of the things that are alleged to have gone on in there have gone on, but there sure is a lot of people making outrageous claims here. We'll continue with the story from The Guardian, but first, we go to Mr. Statesman via Skype, calling from Taco Bell. Mr. Statesman, you're on Free Talk Live. Hello,
you are. Hi there. I'd kind of like to.
Terrible time to take your call.
Discuss,
actually, you're
beating traffic tickets real quick.
Oh, you're back.
I actually
okay.
had a recent experience. I got a. Can you hear me?
Yeah, it was kind of breaking up there for the beginning portion of your call. Hello? So go ahead.
Yeah, I actually got flashed by one of those photo radars down in Tucson, Arizona recently. And I read a little bit online about if you just ignore them, they physically have to serve you via a process server. And I managed to dodge the process server for a period of about 3 months. Mm-hmm. And I checked on the public records just yesterday, and it looks like they dismissed my ticket.
Sweet.
Huh.
Now, is this only in Arizona that this works?
As far as I know, Arizona actually has a law in the books that you must be physically served. Uh-huh. And if you do end up sending those tickets in, you're literally just confessing.
Right. Well, of course. I mean, that's any time that. Whenever you've got a traffic ticket of some sort and they, you know, comes with the envelope where you can just fill out and, you know, check the box and cut the check, that is absolutely a guilty plea. And it they do that because it's easy for them. They don't have to do any work to get the conviction. You made them work for it.
I did. And they ended up not being able to find me. You know, I tend to move along a lot for my job. So it was actually a very simple process.
Excellent. Well, thank you for sharing that.
Do you think that there were people who were walking around, knocking on doors and looking for you?
I doubt it. You can actually look on the public record search and it documents every time that they serve you. Mm-hmm. They only attempted it twice. Once actually on Christmas Eve.
And did they actually, indicate where they attempted it? Did they go to your home, your place of business?
Yeah, it looks like they just go to the address indicated on your driver's license.
Yeah, it's not a whole lot of effort they're putting into looking for you. But then again, you know, they're not going to get a whole lot out of it either. It's just, what was the amount of the ticket?
I believe it was $235 for going 11 miles over the speed limit.
They might want to knock on a door a couple of times. You know, it occurs to me that a person in Arizona or basically anywhere doesn't have to open the door for the police.
That's correct.
So even if they came to the door while this man was at home, He wouldn't have had to step out.
Not only that, you don't even have to step near the door. I mean, you don't have to give any indication that you're home or paying attention to them at all. Now, we're not attorneys, so this isn't legal advice, but that's my understanding of the situation. If somebody is knocking on your door, whether they're the police or some other stranger, you have no obligation to interact with them whatsoever.
But you have every obligation to me to go grab your camera and grab your live streaming device and start doing that.
Well, it's really probably not that interesting unless, you know, the cops are out there talking to themselves, right? Like, there have been a couple instances where I've seen that, where somebody will grab a camera and actually record the police trying to get them to respond,
great,
but they don't respond.
Record silence. Yeah. You know, the worst is you don't use it.
That's true.
Big deal.
Hey, anything else, Mr. Statesman, that you'd like to share with us tonight?
That is it. I just wanted to let everyone know, if you're in Arizona, you do not have to respond to any ticket.
Thanks for the call tonight, man. I appreciate the heads up on that. It's an interesting claim, and I hope that that turns out to be true for other folks.
Yeah, wouldn't that be great if they actually had to work for the money that they're trying to extort from people?
Well, there's always some sort of option. I mean, even if they end up, you know, even if it's a different state where they can just keep coming at you or whatever for this, and they don't have the same rules as Arizona. I know somebody who got one of those tickets for like blowing through an easy pass or something, and they were able to call up the company, because it's a private company that administrates that. So when you challenge it, you're going through the company's administrative process. And they just said they were willing to waive it the first time, like, because, you know, oh, you made a mistake. All right, well, we'll cut you a break this time.
Interesting, because it's just some company. It's not really the police. So is it the company that's also ratting on you to the cops?
That would be the case.
It's like a little fascist partnership that they've got going on.
That's exactly what it is. But it's kind of interesting, right? Because even though the company has a monopoly, right? They've been granted the control over this easy pass system that no one else can compete with, they still act better than the government would, right? Because if you call up the government, if you've got a ticket and you call the government up, whatever issuing agency it was, and you say, hey, I got this ticket here and I didn't really mean to park there that long, or whatever it was that you did, they'll tell you to go screw off and take it to court if you don't like it. But they're not gonna waive it for you just because they want to be nice.
That is so weird, because what is fundamentally the difference between a company that has a monopoly on a service and the police?
There's not that much of a difference, but I guess it's enough of a difference to where they're willing to be a little lenient the first time.
Weird.
The toll-free number here tonight is 855-450-FREE. That is our toll-free number. You can also join us via Skype, as our last caller did. Skype username is lrn.fm. So back to the black site.
Yes.
We talked about the NATO 3. They're going to get a little bit more from one of those guys here in a moment in the story from The Guardian, which is going over what it's like to be inside this place called I keep calling it Hunan. I keep thinking it's like a Chinese word, but it's actually Homan. Homan Square, large facility that you really can't get into unless you are an attorney, and even then they might not let you in. Jacob Church learned about Homan Square the hard way on May 16th of 2012. He and 11 others were taken there after police infiltrated their protest against the NATO summit. Church says officers cuffed him to a bench for an estimated 17 hours, intermittently interrogating him without reading his Miranda rights to remain silent. It would take another 3 hours and an unusual lawyer visit through a wire cage before he was finally charged with terrorism-related offenses at the nearby 11th District Station, where he was made to sign papers, fingerprinted, and photographed. In preparation for the protest, Church, who's from Florida, had written a phone number for the National Lawyers Guild on his arm as a precautionary measure. Once taken to Homan Square, Church
clearly a terrorist, some guy who wants to have the National Lawyers Guild
on
his
call,
arm.
Yeah. He asked explicitly to call his lawyers, and he said he was denied. Quote, essentially, I wasn't allowed to make any contact with anybody, he told The Guardian, in contradiction to the police guidance on permitting phone calls and legal counsel to arrestees. Church's left wrist was cuffed to a bar behind a bench in a windowless cinder block cell with his ankles cuffed together. He remained in those restraints for 17 hours. He said, quote, I had essentially figured, all right, well, they disappeared us, so we're probably never going to see the light of day again. And that's a scary thought to go through your mind. I mean, Dirk J., you and I have been in a jail cell here and there for civil disobedience, acts of civ dis, And we always knew where we were being held, and our friends knew where we were being held, and you know, there was never
And the any... cops would never have any issue with telling other people if asked.
Certainly not here in Keene, New Hampshire, at least. But can you imagine having that thought go through your mind where you're taken to a place that you don't know where you are, and when you're in there, you're cuffed and shackled and restrained in a fairly uncomfortable position for 17 hours, and you think to yourself, well, that's it. I'm probably never going to get out of wherever this place is. I don't know what's happened to me.
Yeah, my first thought, I guess, would be like, well, this can't be legal. How is this happening? You know, like, oh, someone's going to find out about this. But then second follow-up, and if I put myself in their shoes, would be, well, if this has been going on and if this is happening, then there probably is no way out of this. Like, they're not going to just let up. And this article doesn't make it clear where the arrest happens. It sort of sounds like there was a big protest that all of these people were at, and the police just sort of snatched them up from that. So presumably mm-hmm. their friends would know they're missing. That's not the case. Reading from FreeTheNATO3.com, Chicago cops raided an apartment
in a
neighborhood. Yeah, and arrested the 11 people in or around the apartment. So
they took everybody.
Yeah.
And so whoever they didn't take was just probably neighbors, and they wouldn't have known what the hell was going on.
Right. Though all just trumped up political charges.
And this particular raid, this NATO 3 arrests, they attracted major media attention, this raid did. A team of attorneys, even though there was all this attention on the case, they still couldn't find Mr. Church through 12 hours of what they termed active searching. Sarah Gelsomino, Church's lawyer, recalled that no booking record existed. Only after she and others made a, quote, major stink, unquote, with contacts in the offices of the Corporation Council and Mayor Rahm Emanuel, did they ever learn about Homan Square.
Not only were there no records of him being there, there were no charges in the first place for the first month.
We will come back with more. Your thoughts are welcome. 855-450-FREE. Black sites operating right here in America. It's real.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Friday, February 27th, 2015. Gold is trading at $1,210, silver at $16.59, and Bitcoin is trading around $251.47. Today's Bitcoin price brought to you by Express Coin, the fastest and most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at expresscoin.com. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from the Texas Bitcoin Conference, March 28th and 29th at ACL Live at the Moody Theater. Join scores of Bitcoin experts and enthusiasts from around the world for talks, networking, and a $1 million Bitcoin 2.0 hackathon. Tickets on sale now at TexasBitcoinConference.com. In the news, the Washington Times calls it a landmark decision. That follows Thursday's FCC approval of net neutrality, which gives the federal government a major role in oversight of internet traffic. Critics decry the move as a gateway into government oversight of the entire internet. The Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, commonly known as DARPA, is close to completing an advanced voice recognition program. The agency is in the third phase of the Robust Automatic Transcription of Speech, RATS program, which is capable of deciphering human voices even when background noise renders the conversation inaudible. In honor of the launch of the new and improved SovereignLiving.com, each day this week, the Liberty Beat is bringing you a simple survival tip that just might save your life. With today's tip, here's John Bush.
Have a bug-out plan. You never know when a crisis could occur. Some disasters could be so severe that you and your family need to leave your home immediately. It's important that you have a plan as to where you are going to go should you need to vacate your home. Also, if your family or bug-out group members are not in the same place when your crew decides it's time to get the heck out of Dodge, it's important to have a predetermined meeting place so everyone is on the same page and knows where to go. Make sure your plan takes into account what the environment might be like in a disaster or civil unrest scenario. What will major roads be like? Could bridges be down? Could checkpoints be set up? Pre-stock your bug-out location with enough supplies to last you and your crew a month or longer should you need to hunker down for the long haul. Finally, keep your bug-out plan on a need-to-know basis. You don't want the authorities or your neighbor Bob showing up unexpectedly.
Today's broadcast of the Liberty Beat is brought to you by CoinArch, offering innovative online trading solutions for Bitcoin. Visit CoinArch.com and sign up using coupon code MAX and get free brokerage for the first 10 days. It only takes $10 to start an account. That's CoinArch.com. Support also comes from Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, February 27, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. A constitutional lawyer and executive director of the Bill of Rights Defense Committee was arrested by Capitol Police after shouting to Director of National Intelligence James Clapper during a Senate Armed Services Committee hearing. Shahid Buttar joined peace activist Code Pink in protesting Clapper and his involvement in NSA surveillance. Buttar stood up and questioned Clapper about misleading the Senate Intelligence Committee in March of 2013 regarding the mass intelligence gathering performed by the agency. Gemalto, the Dutch SIM card manufacturer, confirmed they were the target of hacking attacks, but denied that the attackers were able to get the SIM card encryption keys. The company reached the conclusion after a week-long investigation following a report from The Guardian that alleged that the NSA and GCHQ hacked the company in 2011. The likelihood of an individual facing an audit from the IRS has dropped to the lowest level in at least a decade. That's according to a new analysis by USA Today. The review found that audit rates from IRS agents fell to 0.86% in 2014. That's the lowest since 2005. Audits fell in nearly every individual category, despite the overall number of individual tax returns rising. The low audit rates coincide with a drop in funding for the IRS and a decrease in revenue agents. Looking to promote your business or cause to tens of thousands of loyal listeners? For a limited time only, the Liberty Beat is offering you the chance to say big while spreading your message. It's simple. Just sign up for 3 months of advertising and get your fourth month free. Don't miss out on this unique opportunity. Just visit thelibertybeat.com/advertise and use coupon code GCN in the Describe Your Company section. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, February 27th, 2015. I'm Brian Hagan reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
Odds are, if you've looked outside recently, you've noticed that all dogs everywhere are running. Scientists can't explain why all over the world, dogs of every breed are running nonstop. I'm joined now by animal behavior expert, Dr. Charles Davenport. Charles, what can you tell us?
All we know for sure is that the dogs are running fast.
But we don't know why the dogs are running?
There are a few reasons that dogs normally run. Because they're excited or scared, or they see something they want far away, or because they're happy. However, usually, they don't run at the same time or in the same direction.
Do we have any idea where the dogs are running?
West. All the dogs are running west.
Do we expect the dogs to ever stop running?
We don't know. Animal behavior can evolve over time. Maybe running forever is just what the dogs do now.
Dr. Davenport, is there any chance that the running dogs are somehow related to last night's blue meteor shower? Or the fact that horses are screaming?
Inconclusive.
Well, please keep us posted. Up next, where are all the children?
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. We're launching into the second hour of this live Saturday edition. You can dial toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Drop by freetalklive.com and enjoy the features we have waiting for you there. With you in studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
And Derek J.
Welcome, by the way, to our newest radio affiliates. We've got WSIC in Statesville, North Carolina, where we are being heard on 100.7 FM, 1400 AM, and for the very first time ever in the history of Free Talk Live, a television broadcast channel.
Whoa, cool.
Pretty cool, yeah. So the I don't know if you remember a few years ago, Derek J., they switched from analog to digital television for over-the-air broadcasts, you know, for the people that still have broadcast receivers, antennas, and that kind of thing.
Yeah.
They went to all digital. And the shift to digital means that one channel, a television channel, doesn't take up as much bandwidth anymore because it's digital, so you can be compressed and smaller than the old analog signals, which means they can fit more than one channel into that sort of space. And so what they have apparently on these TV channels are like sub-channels. So there's the main channel, which in Statesville is 21, but the Free Talk Live's audio is on WSIC, which occupies a sort of a sub-channel. So 21.2. If you're in Statesville, North Carolina, you can actually listen to Free Talk Live through your television set through over-the-air television sub-channel thing.
Does that mean you have to put up an antenna like those rabbit ears that I was familiar with as a kid?
They would be different from the rabbit ears. They would be like special rabbit ears for the new HDTV kind of standard, I guess.
Okay.
But yeah, so we're on television waves now on Free Talk Live, which is pretty cool. So welcome aboard to all of our listeners there in Statesville. If you're just tuning into the show this hour, we've got a lot more to say about the black site in Chicago, this creepy place called Homan Square, where if you are arrested by Chicago police and, well, I don't know what the criteria is. They don't like you. They don't like the way you look. I don't know why they would choose to bring some people to Homan Square before they take them to, you know, a regular booking facility. But essentially, people have been detained in this Homan Square for hours, some up to 24 hours before even being allowed to see an attorney. It can be very, very hard to even determine if somebody that you love or your client, if you're an attorney, is actually in this facility. There are allegations of beatings, head injuries, people being chained up, people being shackled.
There's even some more scary allegations that I want to get to.
I definitely want to get to that. We also have with us Will Coley, who is from Muslims for Liberty. He's on via Skype tonight. Will, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Derek J.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey. Go ahead.
Well, first of all, as far as the black sites are considered, I've always been a big proponent of the idea that whatever you allow the government to do to others, Abu Ghraib, Guantanamo Bay, etc., it will eventually do to you.
That's true.
Black sites in the U.S. So if you're looking for an explanation of why this is happening and why no one really is doing anything about it, it's, well, we've spent the last 14 years not doing anything about it, so why would we start now?
Yeah, it's like principles get compromised a little at a time. Like, oh, well, it's just happening to other people. Well, it's just happening to other people in the U.S.
Yeah, exactly. But I actually had called because, you know, I love you guys because of the fact that when there are things that are happening in the world and the mainstream media isn't really acknowledging it, you guys have put so much work into creating, you know, such a large fan base and such a large network of stations that you can bring stories to you guys and still reach, you know, a huge number of people. And yesterday was Oklahoma Muslim Capital Day. Basically, there's this effort around the country in different states to teach Muslims how to be politically engaged. how to talk to their congressman, how to engage the system, because right now the system seems to be targeting them. So the
Oh, come on, Will Culley. Why don't you just admit it? You just want to implement Sharia law in the United States.
Well, no, I'm an anarchist, so it's really hard for me to even say any of this with a straight face.
Yeah, you know? I'm like, I'm wondering why you would want Muslims to engage with the government. Wouldn't you just want to be like, do your own thing?
But anyway, the quote-unquote solution to the fact that there's all of this, you know, animus in among certain members of the legislature in different states is the fact that Muslims aren't engaged with the government enough. So every time they put one together, there's always these, you know, these protests, these like 20 or 30 people, they drive in from other states, from Florida and Texas and places like that, and they all converge there and have their little protest. And there's this one crazy lady. Everybody knows her as the Monster Energy Drinks or of the Antichrist lady. She goes and always crashes the prayer service that's held. Or if they're singing the national anthem, she'll run up and take the microphone and try to crash the event.
And why is she known as the Monster Energy Drink lady? Is she always wearing like a Monster t-shirt or something like that?
Well, no, she had a video that went viral about 6 months ago of her at a festival where she was talking about how the M on Monster Energy Drinks was actually Hebrew for 666.
Oh, yeah. I've seen that. So, she's crazy.
So, wait,
yeah.
wait.
Well, she,
this is going to backfire, though, Will. I'm seeing this backfiring already because, you know, Muslims getting engaged with government, people are already in the U.S. So terrified of other cultures, including Muslims, that they're going to say, oh, they're trying to implement Sharia law, just as Ian said. Aren't you afraid of that?
Well, I mean, personally, like I said, I'm not a big advocate of anyone being engaged in this directly with the system because, you know, when you sit down to play with the devil, then the devil changes you.
I can make an argument on the side of this, but before we do that, can you please explain what Sharia law is? Because I only trotted that out there because that's what you would hear on Fox News. But I remember we've had you on in the past. There was actually one night we had you on literally for all 3 hours of our Saturday show. And Will just fielded call after call after call.
That was so awesome.
Yeah, of people who didn't have any idea what a Muslim actually believes. And, you know, all they've ever heard about Muslims is from Rush Limbaugh.
It's so needed.
Yeah, so what is Sharia law? What is it actually?
Well, Sharia is it's a decentralized legal code for Muslims specifically. Actually, the third foundation of jurisprudence in Islam is that Sharia applies only to Muslims, that non-Muslims have their own courts and their own ways, and that they should arbitrate amongst themselves, and that Muslims should arbitrate amongst ourselves. You know, in Western society, basically, it would be the code that Muslims live by. I mean, 75% to 80% of Sharia covers religious ritual. You know, how to pray, how to fast, how to wash for prayer properly, how to slaughter animals properly, that sort of thing. But there is this 15% to 20% that covers criminal functions.
Is it barbaric? I mean, is that 15% like, you know, chop off the hand of the thief, eye for an eye kind of stuff?
Well, it is eye for an eye kind of stuff to a point, but as with most legal systems that aren't empirical, it's up to the discretion of the judge. And then there's also a qualification for what they call a dispensation, which is where like there's a ruling that there can be no punishment for theft in times of famine, you know, because people who are put in a state of desperation are likely to steal food to eat. So you can't criminally punish someone because their intent wasn't to be malicious in stealing. Their intent was to feed the child that was starving to death in their house. You know, like they have to return the property, but there can't be any criminal infraction that's seen against them. So they would have to return, you know, a monetary compensation, but there couldn't be any criminal punishment, that kind of thing. So, and it's a legal system that there can be no victimless crimes. So the state can't be a victim. Judges are independent of the state, and they arbitrate victim versus accused. And their only function is to find doubt in the victim's case, in those who are making the accusation's case.
Will, as a Muslim who says that Sharia law is voluntary and is something that is followed by Muslims exclusively and it shouldn't be imposed on others— Would you say that the governments and the states around the world that do impose Sharia law as their form of government law, are they making some sort of mistake?
Well, most of them are patrilineal monarchies, which are expressly forbidden in Islam to begin with.
Hold on a sec. We're gonna, I want to give him a chance to answer that question again in a moment. Hang on, Will. You're kind of breaking up there. We'll ask the question again here when we come back. More on the way. 855-450-FREE. 855-450-3733. We've got Will Cauley with us from Muslims for Liberty. It's Free Talk Live.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Okay, guys, when it comes to shaving, you've got to check out Harry's.com. Why pay $32 for an 8-pack of blades? Harry's high-quality German-engineered blades are half the price of drugstore brands. Harry's starter set with a razor, 3 blades, and shave cream is just $15 with free shipping. With promo code 5858, you get $5 off your first order. After using code 5858 at checkout, you can get an entire month's worth of shaving for just $10. That's Harry's.com, code 5858.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth slide into a recession or at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
A congressman recently revealed that legislation totaling 2,900 pages and involving more than $1 trillion was available to members of Congress for less than 48 hours to study and consider. That's over 60 pages of legislation per hour. Do you think anyone read the entire bill? I'm Jim Babka with DownsizeDC.org. Consider a proposal buried in a 3,200-page, $388 billion bill, which would have empowered committee chairmen or their agents to examine Americans' tax returns. When this horrible provision came to light, no one claimed to know how it got into the bill. One congressman questioned said, "I didn't write it, I didn't approve it, I wasn't even consulted." If your attorney represented you this way, he might be disbarred. But this is how Congress represents you every day. That's why DownsizeDC.org has created the Read the Bills Act. You can force Congress to read their bills before they pass them at DownsizeDC.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
Welcome
back with more Free Talk Live on this live Saturday edition. Of course, you can bring up whatever you'd like, 855-450-FREE. And that is the toll-free number here, 855-450-3733. You've heard about Bitcoin and maybe about blockchain, the technology behind Bitcoin. You can learn a lot more about all of that stuff and all the tangentially related tech that there's just such a wide world to absorb. Learn about a bunch of it over at the second annual Texas Bitcoin Conference. That's where the doers, the movers, the shakers, the big names of the Bitcoin world, a lot of them are going to be there. George Gilder, a famous investor, economist, and author, will be one of the keynote speakers. Also, Simbala Nair, IBM's architect of their blockchain technology, will be flying in from India. David Johnston, Jason King, Robert Murphy, Vitalik Buterin, and somehow Charlie Schrem, allegedly, even though he's supposed to be in prison at that time. TexasBitcoinConference.com. It's going to be the place to be. Austin, Texas, March 28th and 29th. In downtown Austin at the Moody Theater, Free Talk Live will have the pleasure of broadcasting live from the event. We were there last year doing the very same thing, and it was a great time. And I think this one's going to be even better because they're actually having this one in downtown Austin as opposed to sort of on the outskirts where it was last year. So it'll be even better this year. Come on out and join us March 28th and 29th. You can also check out while you're there the second $1 million Bitcoin 2.0 hackathon. And if you use code FTL when you get your tickets, you'll save $25 instantly right off the top of the $150 admission price. And another $25 goes to Sean's Outpost when you use code FTL. And Sean's Outpost is a great Bitcoin-based charity that's helping homeless people in North Florida. So go to TexasBitcoinConference.com and mark your calendar now for March 28th and 29th in downtown Austin. We'll look forward to seeing you there. And don't forget to use code FTL when you get your tickets for the discount. We go back to Will Cully. He's with us from Muslims for Liberty. Will, what's the Muslims for Liberty website?
Muslims4liberty.org.
Muslims4liberty.org. Now, Derek J., can you recap the question you had for Will right before we went to break?
Yeah, Will was saying that Sharia law is a type of voluntary law that only really applies to Muslims and that it isn't something that's imposed on everyone. And so I was saying a lot of my experience in the U.S. with people who are xenophobic towards Muslims would say, oh, they're trying to impose Sharia law on us without really understanding the point that Will just made. Now, what about those countries that do impose Sharia law on everybody, Will? Are they making a mistake?
Well, I think Davi Barker put it best when he categorized them as Western governmental systems with some Islamic paraphernalia draped over them for effect. And, you know, basically.
So it's not true Islam. It's not orthodox in your mind.
It's just power mongers who wear the dress of Islam.
Pretty much, yeah. Well, yeah. I mean, they're government. So, of course, that's what they do. I mean, if you look at Syria or Saudi Arabia or Qatar or UAE, these are all patrilineal monarchies or dictatorships where you get to be king because of who your father or your uncle or your grandfather was.
Yeah.
And that whole idea was expressly forbidden by the Prophet Muhammad SAW. He specifically stated that no man is more fit to rule over another man simply because of who his father is. And that Islam came to do away with this whole idea that one family or tribe or group is fit to rule over everyone else. That there is no, like, patrilineal or matrilineal system. If leadership exists, then it should be based upon merit and should never go to anyone who desires it. And that's the opposite of what you see in Muslim countries. That's literally the opposite of what you see in Muslim countries. So
let's get back to your original point for your call. You'd called to tell us about this Oklahoma day at the Capitol where Muslims were to go and kind of talk to the legislators there for the purpose of sort of being seen and known and, you know, getting politically active. And I wanted to just defend that because, I mean, you guys had both sort of joked about, oh, well, you know, you're anarchists and so you wouldn't, you know, necessarily support doing that. But I can see where they're coming from, and I don't think it's a bad idea, and here's why. So we're here in New Hampshire, Derek J. and I, and in New Hampshire, at least, it's probably a completely different situation than in most states where we actually have an accessible legislature where you can actually go and talk to them. You can actually, you know, if you want, you can open carry a firearm into the legislative chamber. And, you know, these guys are much more down to earth here because they're only getting paid $100 a year. And when you talk to these guys, some of them really do seem like they want to listen. Like, you know, they're actually interested in hearing what you have to say. And it doesn't seem false like it does with a lot of politicians when that happens. And I think there have been a couple of examples that Chris Cantwell's pointed out here on the show where he's been shocked and surprised to actually have New Hampshire politicians stop where they're going. They're like walking down the hallway in the state house. One of them stops and sees Chris, and he's, you know, takes time out of wherever it was that he was going to talk to Chris and give him an update on, you know, one of the bills that he was testifying about the week before. There was another one that he had a conversation with briefly. The guy wanted his contact information. He said he didn't want to give him his anarchist atheist a-hole card.
And Why not?
He gave him one of my cards, and the dude lost the card. So he looked up Chris on Facebook, sent Chris a Facebook message, and they had a chat for like an hour or something about different issues. And the guy called himself a moderate Democrat, and Chris said, I'm a you know, radical anarchist. And the dude wanted to have a conversation, and they talked about some stuff and, you know, where Chris believes on things. And my point is, and I don't know if the same thing would work in Oklahoma or in any other state, but at least here in New Hampshire, I think it would be good for Muslims to show up at the state house and meet these state legislators, because many of these people, all they know about a Muslim is what they've seen on Fox News. And if they can actually meet one, if they could meet you, Will, or somebody else who's as good at communicating, I think that could be a very good thing at preventing people being disappeared into black sites, for instance.
Yeah, right. Very, very, very true. Well, my lament, I guess you could say, about the event was the media coverage of it. They covered the event, of course, and they covered the interfaith group that was there. And they also, of course, covered the protesters, because they acted particularly idiotic, as usual. But what they forgot to mention was the libertarians. I mean, there were tons of libertarians that showed up. The Oklahoma Libertarian Party and other liberty-oriented groups in Oklahoma put out press releases stating that they were joining with Muslims and other more Muslim organizations like Muslims for Liberty and CARE in this event, and supporting Muslims going and getting involved in, you know, in their state legislature. And they formed a chain, a human shield of sorts, between these anti-Muslim protesters and the Muslim attendees as they were coming in the building.
Were they like holding hands, forming a chain?
Pretty much. And I was pretty appalled at the fact that the media couldn't bring themselves to say a group of interfaith workers and libertarians, rather than a group of interfaith workers. Like, it was there, it happened. There were just as many libertarians as there were anti-Muslim protesters or interfaith workers. But that one group just for some reason did not bear mentioning whatsoever in any article by the media that's come out.
And
so
libertarians
far.
Are never worth mentioning.
Unless you're in New Hampshire, in which case we get front page news constantly up here compared to pretty much everywhere else. Will, thanks for the call tonight, man. That's Muslims4Liberty.org. Very informative, as always. And you can share your thoughts, 855-450-FREE. Are you scared of Muslims? It's Free Talk Live. Also, more on the way on the black sites. Plus, your calls coming up about whatever's on your mind. This is the live Saturday edition of Free Talk Live.
By now, you may have heard a bit about Bitcoins, but did you know Bitcoins are now over an $8.5 billion market? And did you know that over 65,000 businesses now accept Bitcoins? Listen, if you're already earning Bitcoins or trying to make money in the Bitcoin market, you've got to know BidBit.co. Why? Because BidBit.co is where you can easily receive Bitcoins by selling and auctioning off your own personal items, or promote business products and services for Bitcoins. You heard right. Whether personal or business, you can now buy, sell, and auction your product and services quickly, easily, and securely for Bitcoin at BidBit.co, the first and only marketplace website to offer BidBit escrow, a proprietary technology which gives buyers and sellers security and peace of mind because all transactions are protected. Start today. It's free to join, free to post, free to auction, and free to bid at BidBit.co. Buy, sell, bid, or auction everything Bitcoin. That's www.bidbit.co. BidBit.co.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself.
it called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here. And I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting bloc and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial toll-free here and bring up whatever you'd like. We're here live on the Saturday edition of Free Talk Live. We do the show live 7 nights a week. You can join us online, of course, anytime over at freetalklive.com. And don't forget to join Derek J. on his website, derekj.me. And what will people find, Derek J., if they visit you on your website?
They'll find lots of videos and podcasts. You know, I used to take lots of videos about what's happening here in Keene. Not doing that so much anymore. Focusing on podcasts like Cop Block Radio and Flaming Freedom, a gay sex podcast. And there's also, you know, Cop Block is special too because we talk with police officers like Straight Razor, who was on earlier, talking about what their experiences are like actually on the streets, violating people's rights. Yeah, it is cool. Yeah, so that's what people can see, all sorts of behind-the-scenes call-in type entertainment.
And the occasional video that you still shoot when you get the chance to do.
Yeah,
that.
I do. Like, I filmed a school board meeting here in Keene, New Hampshire that was pretty unique in the sense that there were lots of activists sort of overwhelming it and throwing a wrench in the works.
I have heard that there's going to be an edited version of that. That was a 6-hour-long meeting. You shot the very beginning of it. Sort of in total.
Yeah, but it's also getting a great reaction already. I mean, when I was there, I like to do uncut videos. It really shows what it's like behind the scenes. And one of the things that I showed was activists not standing for the Pledge of Allegiance and just sort of panning the room as people showed their disgruntled looks at everyone for not going
along. Oh, really? Did they
along.
Shoot you some glares for that one?
Oh, yeah. People were very upset. And I think that's cool, you know, to see what's happening in Keene. Is that happening where you live? Are people populating the city council and school board meetings and, you know, throwing in Warren articles and not standing for the pledge?
Seems unlikely. There's so much happening here in New Hampshire. It's really hard to get it's hard to really understand how much is really going on because we can only experience a portion of it. We try to give you a little bit of a slice of it. DerekJ.me is a great site to visit. Also, you blog over at freekeene.com. And sort of related, I did post a real quick update to the blog tonight announcing that with the latest mover to Keene, who just moved in today, Marcel, he is living actually across the street from the LRN.FM studios in the so-called capitalist house.
Another gay anarchist.
Right, so we've got now. Does this increase the gay activists in Keene by 100%?
Yeah, roughly. I think so. Well, we can never be 100% sure, right?
That's true. At least that we know of.
Yeah.
And so Marcel, but more notably, is actually one of the top 40 under 40. One of the top 40 liberty minds under 40, as listed by Tony Styles, who's a liberty-oriented talk show host out of Omaha. He came up with this top 40 list that includes Christopher Cantwell, who is, of course, our Wednesday night co-host here on Free Talk Live. You were actually the number one person on the list, though I hear it wasn't in any particular order.
Sure.
And I was also on that list. And now with Marcel moving to town, he was on the list. That means we actually have 10%, four out of the 40 people who, you know, this is an international list of the most, you know, supposed top 40 liberty minds under the age of 40, and 10% of them live here in Keene, which I just think is pretty awesome.
Yeah, Keene is a very unique place.
It does attract some of the outstanding activists out there. So you can come join us. Go check out the Free State Project at freestateproject.org and make a move to where there are actually people who care about freedom. Mike, you're on in Clackamas, Oregon, listening to LRN.FM.
Hey guys, how you doing tonight?
Good. Go ahead, sir.
Derek J, finally get a chance to talk to you. This is my first time being able to talk to you. I wanted to mention before I talk about what I originally called in about. One of my favorite videos that you did. It was back in 2000, probably 8 or 2009. The parasitic nature of the state. I think that's an awesome video that you have.
2009. What were you doing in 2009, Derek J? Because you hadn't moved to Keene yet. Were you doing much video work back then?
Yeah. This is a 2012 video that I did when it was a show that I was going to start with one of the fellow activists here, Ryan Maddox, who did a couple of episodes. This was in the very early days of my YouTube creations. And the show was called Freedom Singularity. And episode number one was called Parasitic Nature of the State.
Huh. So the show never really got out of the box, but somebody remembered it.
There were a few hundred views on this episode, so thank you for being one of them, Mike.
Oh, I got to tell you, that's one of my favorite videos, and I actually have it saved in my YouTube channel. And I think, you know, a lot of people, when, you know, you talk about what the state is, they think of, you know, the state, you know, local government. And actually, before I watched the video, that's what I thought it was about, opposing federal government, but saying the state government is actually bad. But when I, you know, the more I watched it, the more I delved, you know, went into the video, I found out that the state is strictly an idea of violence, you know, organized violence. So I just want to say thank you for that. That's a great video. But anyways, I want to talk about something that, Ian, that you had mentioned briefly last night. You and Johnson had gone to break about net neutrality. And it was just last night that I finally caught on to what this is really all about. It was confused me for a while. And that is being able to, when this net neutrality comes into effect, what's going to happen when we use something like ProXPN? This is scary.
Okay, so ProXPN is a sort of virtual private network and there are a variety of companies out there offering similar services that allow you to essentially create an encrypted tunnel within the existing internet that you have to the VPN server, where it then puts out your signal, if you will, to the rest of the internet, so it provides you with a decent layer of privacy. Is your concern that the FCC's control over the internet, their newfound control through this net neutrality Title II vote that went on this week, will result in restrictions being placed on VPNs?
Not so much the restrictions on the service itself, because, I mean, ProXPN, as I understand it, is a private company. But my concern is is when you go to connect with it. I mean, from what you're telling me is that the FCC and the government is going to be regulating every aspect of the Internet, which means, I mean, they're not stupid. I mean, they do know that VPNs exist. And what I'm worried about is when you go to connect to ProXPN and you actually go to the website, is the website going to block access to you visiting it because you're using a VPN? Now, this might be far-fetched. But
oh, I see what you're saying. Okay, so what you're saying is that you're concerned that with the new FCC's control, that they could tell Internet service providers, hey, block any access from these IP ranges that are owned by ProXPN. Prevent these VPN providers from allowing their clients to even access sites in the United States.
Correct. And
it could happen. I mean, whether it will or not is, up to total speculation. I think there's also some real legitimate concerns about censorship. To me, that's one of the big, blaring red light kind of warnings coming out of this one, that the FCC, which is known for censoring television and radio, it seems like that might be coming soon. But they could do what you're suggesting.
Well, it's not too far off, because I actually, before I moved from New Hampshire to Oregon, there's a radio station I used to listen to in the North Country, New Hampshire, WSSX, I think it is, and they're out of Lancaster. Now, they have a live stream on the Internet, so I can listen to that station on my MacBook Pro. Well, when I go to connect to ProXPN and then I go to that stream, it won't let me stream. It says that there's a problem with the stream. So, and also, certain Yahoo sites, like if you click on certain Yahoo News links, you're connected to ProXPN, it says you do not have permission to access it. So if they're doing it without the FCC controlling, just think what they're going to be able to do with the FCC controlling.
Yeah, well, whatever it's going to be, and we don't know what's going to come down the pike, but it's going to be more control. It's going to be more taxes. Good chance of some censorship coming around the bend at some point. They're acting like right now, the official line is, this is going to help keep the Internet open and free. I think there was some kind of White House tweet that went out, praising the FCC for this 3-2 vote that essentially puts more government control over the Internet service providers, the main broadband kind of providers out there. Mike, thanks for the call tonight. Legitimate concern, I would say. 855-450-FREE. Derek J., you had some comments on net neutrality, I believe. So let's get to those. We get the chance. Also, your calls and thoughts are welcome here at 855-450-FREE. That's the toll-free number. You can join us via Skype as well. Skype username here tonight is lrn.fm. There's more Free Talk Live on the way. This is the live Saturday edition.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
This alert just came in. This special announcement is for business owners and leaders of organizations who've been waiting for the right time to build. General Steel has made it impossible to wait any longer with rock-bottom prices that could save you thousands. That's right, General Steel, America's leader in pre-engineered structures, is offering buildings at prices you will never see again. Don't miss these prices. A 50 by 100 for $35,000. You heard right, that's 5,000 square feet for $35,000. Manufacturers, if you need a larger building, try a 100 by 100 commercial building for $129,000. You can't afford to rent with these prices. Imagine a 70 by 100
square-foot church building for under $69,000. With the economy improving and interest rates still at historic lows, you can't afford to wait. So call 866-91-STEEL. Lock in your price now. Call 866-91-STEEL. That's 866-917-8335.
There is no such thing as attention span, according to Jerry Seinfeld, who figures that people have an infinite attention span if you are entertaining them. Hey, he's kept us from channel surfing for several decades, and now he's making more millions as a Las Vegas headliner. With money and attention so scarce now, effective communication skills have never been more important, especially if you're looking for work. So choose every single word as though it was the last word the person you're speaking to will hear. Otherwise, it might be. Avoid redundancies such as added bonus, advance warning, end result, prior history, or personal belongings. And avoid cliches like the plague. Just kidding. For more tips, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Stouffer's, helping bring your family together with wholesome dinner options, even on the busiest of nights. Find dinner table ideas to bring your family together at letsfixdinner.com. To get kids involved in dinner time conversation, ask specific questions, not broad ones. Instead of what happened today at school, try what was the best thing that happened today. The more specific you are, the more they'll have to say. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial toll-free here, 855-450-FREE. That's the number, 855-450-3733. And you can join us online. Just drop by freetalklive.com with you in studio. Ian here.
Derek J.
And don't forget to, again, support the show. One of the best ways to do it is to become a Free Talk Live amplifier. It's $5 a month to AMP Free Talk Live. AMP stands for Advertise, Market, and Promote. And the idea is you send in $5 a month, and then we take that in and invest it into Free Talk Live, getting on more radio stations around the country. We just announced WSIC Tonight, our newest station in Statesville, North Carolina. All of the stations that we have, over 150 AM and FM stations from coast to coast and beyond, as far away as Guam and the Virgin Islands, as a matter of fact, probably 90% of those stations are on board because of the AMP program, because we can afford to do marketing for Free Talk Live. We're going to, in a few months, be going to a Talkers conference where we'll be in New York City schmoozing it up with the big wigs in radio. We can afford to do that stuff because of listeners like you who get behind the show for $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com. Plus, we've been talking about the AMP, I keep calling it a t-shirt. It's not a t-shirt. It's a long sleeve performance material shirt. It's on this wicking tech fabric. It's got a word cloud design. It's a exclusive AMP Platinum perk. If you become a Free Talk Live Platinum amplifier by March 8th, the end of the Liberty Forums, you've got about a week left in this. It was going to end tonight. It's been extended for one more week. So if you become a Free Talk Live Platinum amplifier by March 8th and you stay a Platinum for at least 2 months, you will get one of these shirts. And they look pretty cool. You can see them over at shirt.freetalklive.com. That'll take you right to a Facebook post with the pictures front and back. And you'll see the word cloud design and what this looks like. It looks pretty sharp. And you can go to shirt.freetalklive.com. And to sign up as a Platinum amplifier or as some other amplifier, you can go to amp.freetalklive.com as we go to your calls and thoughts here. Robert is in Panama City. You're on Free Talk Live. Robert.
Hey, guys.
Hey,
sorry to bother you at work. I wanted to touch on a topic from Wednesday. Derek J. called in about a boy in Florida that had been court-ordered to have a circumcision at 5 years old. And I was actually circumcised at 5 years old. The only difference is it was my choice. I had noticed the little boys in the boys' room, their parts were different than mine, and I asked my parents, and they explained it to me in an adult fashion. And I actually chose at that point to become circumcised. The assertion that was made, I believe by Cantwell, was that, or maybe Derek, that if the child was given the choice, he might not choose. At five, it's a hard choice. I think if I had been told to wait till 10 or 11 or 15, I probably would not have chosen to have it done.
Well, that's what I was going to say, is it doesn't seem to me that at 5 years old you really possess the ability to have enough perspective and understanding on the issue to make an informed choice in that matter.
Most parents don't allow their five-year-old children to make permanent decisions like getting tattoos or piercings.
Yeah, and looking back on it as an adult, I'm in my 30s, it seemed odd that they did allow me to make that decision. But like I said, if I had been given that choice later in life, I would not have made it. I can't change it now. I have no regret. But Mark had brought up ear piercing, and ear piercing's a little different. Ear piercing's close. You know, you get baby's ears pierced, and it may not be a detrimental thing. This was a change I made at 5 years old that affected me for the rest of my life.
Yeah, that's true. And of course, you know, some people will point out that one of the real detriments to circumcision is that they're literally snipping away, oh, I don't know, what, millions of nerve endings? I mean, so essentially it sort of deadens the sensation to the penis in that particular area, which could possibly result in less pleasure, sexual pleasure later on in life, which is one of the reasons why it, you know, came about as a practice in the first place, was to try to prevent people from desiring sex, which of course it didn't do. It didn't stop people's desire for sex. It didn't do anything like that. It just, you know, it just snips babies' penises. It's kind of sick and barbaric, in my opinion. But yeah, so thanks for sharing your story, Robert. Anything else you want to share with us tonight?
That was it. Thanks so much.
Appreciate hearing from you.
How'd you like to be the doctor in that case? The one, you know, the court appointed that, these parents agreed that this circumcision is supposed to happen. So, you know, bang, gavel hits the table and they say, give this boy a circumcision. Well, how'd you like to be the doctor who just has to follow this order? You know, despite all the protesting happening outside your office, despite the international attention this story is getting.
So the doctor doesn't want to do this job? I mean,
presumably he does, but he did cancel. That was the news I was reporting on Wednesday. He canceled his decision to perform this circumcision because of all the public pressure outside of his doctor's office.
So then he's obviously not obligated to do it, right, if he can just cancel it.
Yeah, but some doctor is going to have to do this, right? And my question for them is just like, you know, how's it feel to be this person who's like, yeah, all right. Yeah, I know everyone wants me to not take a knife to this boy's penis, but I'm going to do it.
Well, I mean, obviously these guys were making money off of this, so they don't have a problem doing it.
Yeah, is it just, are they just going to go home and say, well, that paycheck was so worth it?
I don't know. He might laugh all the way to the bank. It could be good publicity for him. I mean, there are people out there who want circumcisions, and he could be, you know, he could gain name recognition as the doctor to choose if you want to snip your baby's penis up.
Okay.
That's my best I got for you. Robert's listening in Conway, listening to KSMD. Hello, Robert. That's Conway,
hey,
Arkansas.
Guys, good evening.
Hey there. Go ahead with your thoughts.
Well, actually, you guys are the second radio station where this news is breaking. We broke it in Little Rock today. You know, last week there was all over the media, there was an announcement, there was a bill to decriminalize marijuana at the federal level.
I heard something about either decrim or legalization at the federal level.
Right.
But what's newsworthy about it? I mean, just because it's a bill doesn't mean it's going to pass, right?
Well, no, here's what it is. It's not a bill. All the news says it was a bill to legalize. It is not a bill. It's a House resolution, which can never become law.
So it's just a we're saying this kind of thing.
Exactly.
We proclaim such and
exactly.
such.
Exactly. But the actual bill is written up. It says a bill to decriminalize marijuana at the federal level to leave the states the power to regulate marijuana that is similar to the power they have to regulate alcohol and other purposes. But every news station out there reported it that a bill had been introduced to legalize.
Oh, I see what you're saying. So wait. So just to clarify, what you're saying is there is a bill, but that's a decriminalization bill, meaning it will reduce criminal penalties.
Well, no, it says a bill to decriminalize marijuana at the federal level. That's what the title of the bill is. However, it is not a bill. It is a House resolution.
What's the difference?
I thought that's the same. I'm confused.
It was filed as a resolution, not a bill.
So what's a resolution then?
Okay, a resolution, the House or the Senate can file what they call simple resolutions. They're filed, in this particular case, as an HR and then a number behind it, a House resolution.
Yeah.
And they resolve to look at it and discuss it and see what they need to do with it. It can never become law. Now, if it's filed with the same text and the same title and the same name, but it's filed as an HB, i.e. House bill, and a number, then it becomes law.
I see.
Huh. So this is nothing more than a symbolic thing.
It's a nothing more than smoke and mirrors, see what we're doing, but they're not doing anything.
Well, at least in D.C., some of the other news this week was that Washington, D.C. did actually go through a partial legalization of cannabis. It's not going to be available for sale in stores,
right,
but possession of it is now legal.
Well, actually, in D.C., you can grow and use recreational in your own personal residence.
That's correct.
Okay. Now, again, that was done by the federal government because the House did not act on that. I think it was 71. It was issue 71.
Well, they did try to. Right. It was something that was voted on overwhelmingly, by the way, over 70%.
Right. And see how that works. The mayor has got to file with the U.S. Congress. They have 30 days to either shoot it down or allow it or take no action. And if they take no action, it becomes law.
That's right.
If they shoot it down, it doesn't become law.
Well, what they ended up doing was there was some bill where they thought that they had stopped it, but the people in the D.C. city council and the mayor basically said, no, you didn't stop this. We're going to go ahead with it anyway. And then a couple of the Republican drug war hawks in Congress. Thanks for the call, Robert. I appreciate it. A couple of the Republican drug war hawks said, well, we're going to have you arrested, basically. They threatened the mayor of D.C., and her bureaucrats with arrest. So you've got one of those situations where the government is fighting the government, which I love.
Great.
I love it when that happens. And hopefully it'll end up actually on the side of legalization. So right now you've got a situation where it is legal in Washington, D.C. to walk around with, I think it was up to 2 ounces of cannabis. You know, can have it in your home. You can have it on your person. You just can't smoke it in public. So there's still some restrictions on it, but it's much more legal now, and they're going to make it so that the smell of marijuana is no longer a justification to perform a search. So these are important changes that are happening, and there are some people in the federal government who say they're going to arrest the people that are working for the D.C. government, and then this may end up being a court case that goes up to the Supreme Court as far as, you know, how are laws supposed to be made in Washington, D.C., and was this done legally? Either way, right now, the D.C. cops won't arrest you for it.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Gabino lives in Palcapata, Peru. He buys old appliances like irons, radios, and TV sets, fixes them up, and resells them. He saw an opportunity to expand his business and needed a loan to buy more appliances. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan, and the expansion was a success. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. coffee.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, February 28th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.60 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,213 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $253. Antiwar.com reports, as he does every 90 days, President Barack Obama has once again obtained a renewal for the NSA's bulk surveillance of Americans' phone records from the FISA court. While renewals last year gained a lot more publicity in anticipation of reforms being debated in Congress, ultimately no reforms were ever passed, and the NSA program continues to operate as is, collecting metadata without serious limits. This may be the last time, however, as the USA Patriot Act clauses underpinning the administration's claims that this invasion of Americans' privacy is legal are scheduled to expire on June 1st. While Congress doesn't seem interested in tackling reforms to the program, extending the USA Patriot Act clauses, having seen how they've been abused, will be something else entirely, an extremely controversial question which is sure to be hotly debated.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports the U.S. Congress passed legislation late Friday to fund the Department of Homeland Security for an additional week, a move to give lawmakers more time to find a long-term solution and avoid a partial shutdown of what is called one of the nation's most vital national security agencies. The Senate, earlier on Friday, approved $40 billion to fund the Department of Homeland Security through September, but the House of Representatives ignored that bill because it did nothing to nullify President Obama's immigration directives. The House then attempted to pass its own bill, which leaders considered preferable to the Senate version, and fund the department through March 19th. However, Republicans suffered a humiliating defeat when that attempt was shut down by a vote of 203 to 224. When that failed, House Republicans unexpectedly found themselves facing a fast-approaching shutdown and no solution in sight. Hoping to secure a last-minute deal, the Senate then held a voice vote to approve a week-long funding bill. The House then quickly adopted that measure by a vote of 357 to 60.
You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans program. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. To learn more or to join the Fans program, visit fans.fppradio.com. That's fans.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports consumers in Colorado bought more than 17 tons of recreational cannabis during the first year of the state's new retail market, but sales of medicinal cannabis still outstripped that at almost 50 tons. In a national first, voters in Colorado and Washington State opted to legalize recreational cannabis used by adults in landmark twin ballots in 2012. The first retail stores opened in Colorado on January 1, 2014. States such as Oregon and Alaska that have now also voted to legalize recreational cannabis and others where lawmakers face proposals to do so are watching the Colorado's results closely. State tax officials say sales hit nearly $700 million last year, with medical cannabis accounting for $386 million and recreational cannabis bringing in $313 million. In its first annual report, the Colorado Department of Revenue's Cannabis Enforcement Division said 49.5
5.7 tons of medical cannabis were sold in 2014, while 17.5 tons were sold in the recreational market. It said 322 retail stores were licensed at the end of last year, up from about 200 6 months earlier, while 833 licenses were issued to retail businesses in general, and 1,416 medical cannabis businesses were approved by the state. Supporters say voters have chosen to take the trade out of the hands of criminals, and a Quinnipiac University poll this week showed that 58% of Colorado residents support marijuana legalization, while only 38% are opposed. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Thank you, Jord. I appreciate you taking up this issue.
Back off, a man ain't cooked crisp on the hellfire desert, and he ought to be left on his own.
Well, right, Jord. Immigrants are desperate for a better way of life.
We need the strongest of these crude backward browns to keep us all alive. I see the ones that can swim the Rio Grande, too. Berto, you swum that border river to get here, ain't you?
Joe, not all Mexicans came here by swimming the Rio Grande.
No. I got sympathy. I crossed Huron Lake in a barrel myself using hands as paddles, lived off the carp. What jumped at me? Now, you swum that river,
no,
ain't you?
No, Joe, actually, I was born here.
What you know about hard work? Ain't never swum no river.
Many immigrants, they
I say you ain't never
be-
knowed a man till you seen his teeth. Show him your teeth. Too many teeth rotting out shows you're dishonest in the mind. You got strong, manful teeth, Barto. I apologize.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You can join us here toll-free on this live Saturday edition of the program. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. If we get a chance, we'll come back around to the Black Site in Chicago, a place where police in Chicago have been taking people and making them disappear for a period of time before them showing back up, usually in some cases just released back onto the streets with no charges after having been shackled and cuffed and held for hours on end with no access to an attorney or a phone call, or in some cases taken to an actual booking facility where they're actually charged and, you know, then the lawyers can get in touch with them. There's some disturbing, more disturbing news about that that I'd like to share with you when we get the chance. Either way, we'll post up the full details on our Facebook, Google Plus, and Twitter. And of course, you can dig in as deep as you'd like there. But first, we go to your calls. By the way, with you in studio, Ian here.
And Derek J.
Let's go first to Pat. He's in Norfolk, Virginia, listening to WNIS. Pat, you're on Free Talk Live on the live Saturday show.
Hey, how you guys doing?
Good, hey. Pat. Go ahead.
Man, I got a couple things I want to talk about. I just see what kind of opinions you guys might have on it. Earlier I was watching CNN. They were talking about the Afghanistan avalanche that killed like 130 plus, I think, people.
Oh, no.
Yeah. I mean,
Yeah, I hadn't heard about that, okay. Pat. So there was an avalanche. Some folks from Afghanistan, they perished in the avalanche. That sounds horrifying.
Yeah. I mean, I didn't know they had such bad weather over there.
I don't think avalanches really necessarily have to do with bad weather sometimes. Was it a snowy avalanche? I don't think they have much snow in Afghanistan, do they? I mean, I don't know the weather way.
No, I didn't catch all the details.
It's probably just has to do with some rocks falling on people. I mean, usually that's what an avalanche
is just
all about.
Googled Afghanistan avalanche, and the first couple of results were like 2000, 2010, 2012, 2014.
So it seems
like it happens a lot.
So, Pat, how are you doing tonight, man? You having a good Saturday alone?
Yeah.
Right.
I'm originally from the West Coast.
Yeah.
And they got a lot of mudslides back home compared to, you know, avalanches and stuff like that.
You got to watch out for those mudslides, especially if you're sliding them down your throat. Thanks for the call, Pat. I appreciate it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. And, yes, as long as you can dial a phone, you can call Free Talk Live. In fact, if you can't dial the phone, hand it to someone who can, and then they can hand it back to you. And then you can get on Free Talk Live. Hey, Derek J., before we go back to the black site thing, you had mentioned you had some comments on net neutrality. Now, for our listeners maybe that hadn't heard the news, it was a couple of days ago, maybe it was yesterday, the FCC voted 3-2 down party lines to vote to give the FCC, what do you know, the FCC voted to give themselves more control, to give them dramatic levels of control over all aspects, according to one of the FCC commissioners, of the internet.
Yeah, this concerns me because I like fast internet speeds.
I like free internet too, like to where, you know, you're free on the internet and people can't tell you what to do and say. I like that too.
Yeah, I like that, but more than free, I like fast. I'd rather have my entertainment in a slave world come to me quickly than be able to type stupid words.
You don't mean that.
I'm not really sure I could choose between both. But, you know, the points that were brought up by first that caller a few hours ago about net neutrality and then you were honestly not the first thoughts that occurred to me about this net neutrality thing. When I first heard about it, my concern was over the speed. And yeah, I get that freedom is important, but without the incentive for companies like Netflix and, I don't know, whatever, Hulu, whatever sorts of websites deliver lots of intense, I don't know what you would call it, where it needs a lot of bandwidth for videos and stuff. There's a lot of information going down the pipe. So
yeah, I've heard
speak.
Netflix the is like 30% of the internet or something ridiculous like
that. Wow. Yeah, I didn't know about that. But yeah, there are some websites that require more use from your internet than others. And those are the websites that are working on developing ways to get people faster internet, you know, either to encrypt their data that's being sent from point A to point B so that it's a smaller package when it gets there or whatever. These are the companies that are developing innovative ways that we use the internet. Mm-hmm. And obviously, as you said, like Netflix being something like 30% of internet usage.
That's what I've heard. I don't know if it's true.
Well, that would indicate that, you know, they have every incentive to grow the ability of people to use the internet.
Sure.
So anyway, I'm talking about incentives here. So when you remove the incentives from these major companies to innovate and you just say, well, you're all going to be on an equal playing field, they could just as easily divert their limited time and resources towards other ventures. And it's not going to be towards increasing speed.
Well, one of the points that was made, I don't know if it was the Mises Institute, they had a good write-up about net neutrality. They pointed out that the more regulation there is in a business, the more time and effort that business will spend appeasing the regulators than appeasing their customers. So they only have so much, you know, employees and time and money and things like that. And, you know, as the regulations become more extreme and more controlling, it becomes more and more of an interest of the company to hire lobbyists and to hire people to go and, you know, lobby for the legislation to be their way or try to reduce the damage from the legislation as opposed to actually providing customer service to their customers. So this is likely, you know, one of the other effects of this is going to make these big mega corporations that are already hard enough to deal with for people even more unresponsive and even worse in the area of customer service. They'll be serving the bureaucrats prior to serving their actual customers.
Yeah. I wonder if they see that already and the companies that wanted net neutrality were the ones who could foresee that they were already in bed with the government and would get special favor. And those who were not maybe so cozy were the ones opposing it. Like, I wonder how political it was up front. But the other point was, and this was made on CNBC earlier while they were having the CEO of Tumblr on, who's a big supporter of net neutrality. And they were asking him some pretty simple questions about why he supports it. And he couldn't answer them. And
really?
I just found that to be hilarious. Yeah, one of the questions he was asked was, you know, Verizon says that they... you know, this guy was saying, oh, well, they have a monopoly, all these people, it needs to be broken up, and that's why the FCC regulating this is going to make the internet more fair. And so the correspondent asked him, well, Verizon says that they have something of a monopoly because it's very expensive for companies to lay the infrastructure that they would have to compete with people like Verizon. So it's just very expensive. It's not that there's some other barrier here. It's just a natural barrier. I mean, the government can't really fix that, can they? You don't have an answer for that. And also, they're saying that they already spend millions of dollars on building innovations like research and development to make the internet faster for people.
Sure.
Now they don't have an incentive to do that. So why would they continue? And he has no answer for that either. I mean, the supporters of net neutrality, I think, are well-meaning, but haven't really thought through what the effects of changing the incentives are going to be.
Yeah, you're right. This isn't something that people have been thinking through. It's something where they say, oh, that's not fair. You know, company X is paying for special prioritized bandwidth. And there certainly are problems with the internet that have to do with how the government has set things up in the first place to prevent competition, that this going to the government is not going to help things. But yet people don't think things through. All they know is it's essentially like an elementary school level of thought process. It's like, I don't know if you remember this, but I don't remember doing this when I was in school, but I bet they had me do it. It's just been so long since I've been in school. We've definitely seen evidence that they have these assignments these days where they'll tell people in elementary school, like kids in elementary school, all right, kids, you get to be the president for a day. What do you want to do? And then, you know, the sort of this open-ended question of, okay, how can I use government to mold the world to be more like I want it?
You have a magic wand today, kids. What are you going to do with it?
It's not a thought experiment about what happens after that.
Yeah, because they don't have to see any of the consequences for their actions.
Exactly. The toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE, whether you want to talk about net neutrality or the really scary sounding black site that has been revealed in Chicago. Are there more than one? That we don't know yet. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number here. It's the live Saturday edition, and this is Free Talk Live.
Here's a special message for those of you who owe the IRS at least $10,000 or more in back taxes. The IRS has special programs in place that could eliminate or reduce your tax debt by thousands of dollars. Call the tax helpline that has been set up to help you. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. Stop the wage garnishments, levies, and tax liens now. Once you've qualified and enrolled, the IRS will stop all the collection activities against you. These unique programs have been allocated to help the economy and significantly reduce or eliminate your tax burden. The IRS is currently accepting reduced settlements and other favorable programs. You may qualify for substantial savings, so get the help you need. For free information and to see if you qualify, take down the number now for the Tax Representation Hotline. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. 800-691-6129.
Gold, it's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
Free Talk Live.
You know, and this is a realistic view. Look, your kids are going to do drugs. Would you rather them do drugs with pimply-faced kids driving around town? Or would you rather them smoke pot in your house where you know what they're doing? I'm not saying I love the idea of my little boy who's three growing up and smoking pot. I don't. I would prefer he didn't. But I know that the human animal, as it is, likes to have its mind altered. And he's my son. He's probably going to do these things. And I'll tell you, I was in a lot of dangerous situations that if my parents had tried something different, maybe things would have worked out differently. I don't know. I'm not blaming them or anything like that. I'm just saying that we need to try new things. This war on drugs, not working.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, the live Saturday edition. Join us here on the phones at 855-450-FREE, toll-free number 855-450-3733. Or join us via Skype. A number of our callers are on Skype tonight. In fact, we're going to be going back to Skype here in a little bit. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. More coming up, we get the chance about the Chicago Black site where prisoners are being taken, people who are in police custody, just after arrest to be interrogated without being read their Miranda rights, allegedly, perhaps be beaten. There have been some head injuries sustained in this facility, people being shackled for hours on end.
There's also been groin stomping, and I'll get to that.
Oh, gosh. All right, well, we'll get into as much as we can here, but your calls come first. We're going to go to your phones. Phone calls here in a moment. First, we'll let you know about Express Coin. If you've been thinking about getting Bitcoins, now's probably a good time. It seems to be kind of hovering around the $250 price point. Bitcoins have been as high as, you know, $1,000. So, you know, you could look at this as a discounted opportunity to get Bitcoins. One of the best places to do it, expresscoin.com. It's the best choice for getting your cryptocurrencies, not just Bitcoins, but also Litecoin or Dogecoin. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. Plus, they've jumped through the government hoops. They're a licensed money services business. You can get your cryptocurrencies with money order, check, or wire transfer. Start off at expresscoin.com, whether in the U.S. or Canada. That's expresscoin.com. Plus, they've got a smartphone app that you can download at expresscoin.com. And don't forget, when you check out, use coupon code FTL, like Free Talk Live, to get up to $40 worth of your cryptocurrency of choice with no transfer fee at all. ExpressCoin.com. Coupon code is FTL. We go to Jay. He's listening in Indianapolis to WIBC-FM. Hey, Jay.
Hey, how's it going?
Welcome, sir. Go ahead with your thoughts.
Hey, I just want to give a shout-out to my cousin who doesn't have a lot of money at home, but he believes in strongly in the Constitution, and he drove all the way up to Chicago last night to be there today to protest that factory or warehouse or whatever.
Really?
They're using. And
the black
site. Yeah, absolutely. I just want to give a shout out to all them guys out there in the 18 degree weather. Protesting.
We generally
today.
Don't do shout outs here on Free Talk Live, but it's interesting that that's happening out there. So how long has this protest been going on now? Is this today?
I'm not sure. I just know that, you know, that guy doesn't have a whole lot of money, and he up and left and said he's got to get up there. And he just said it's just not right. And he believes in the Constitution and we got to get this thing sorted out soon before it gets out of control.
Well, that's the tricky part, and we haven't gotten to that part of this conversation yet, and I'm glad you kind of brought us back around here, Jay, because we were talking about this black site, the scary place that people are being taken, held for hours on end. There's no way to know who's in there. The attorneys can't reach their clients. The Chicago government saying everything's on the by the book. Everything here is legal. We're not doing anything illegal. This is all totally fine. Attorneys are saying differently. What do you do about that? I mean, standing outside with signs is nice, but we've stood outside the jail with signs here a lot here in Keene, New Hampshire, and you know it doesn't do much good besides getting you a honk and a wave every now and then.
Well, you know, I guess the more people you inform, if you don't start informing people, then they'll never realize what's actually going on.
That much is true.
If we have some concrete evidence either way, this just isn't a figment of people's imagination, you know?
You know, you can inform people without spending money traveling someplace and wasting your time
traveling
outside.
From Indianapolis. I mean, it's not that far, right?
My point is you can stay at home and turn on your camera and inform people on YouTube or on a blog post or write a letter to your editor.
Yeah, but I mean, Derek, you went down to New York City during the Ross Ulbricht trial. I mean, you certainly didn't have to go there to inform the jurors about their right to engage in jury nullification.
I disagree. In that scenario, I needed to reach people physically on the ground. The point was
I think that since this isn't a racially devised protest, this is something that relates to all people of all skin color. I think it really took at them. You know, this is something that you should be protesting, and it doesn't have to be racially, with the latest in Ferguson and New York City and all that. This is something that transcends race. So
I don't know where the race conversation came from, but hey, thanks for the call tonight.
When it comes to protest, I think, people are afraid to, get out there and show their will. So have a good night.
Hey, thanks for the call tonight. Look, I'm not going to down somebody, Derek, just because they want to travel to go to a protest. I don't think that's a bad thing. I mean, if somebody's going to make
I hope I didn't come off as downing him. I'm just saying you can get more bang for your buck, so to speak, by staying at home.
Yeah, but if you're going to make media about what's happening in Chicago with this black site, if this is what's exciting to you, this is what's motivating. The dude saw the story and he thought, "Wow, that's really outrageous.
I gotta go there.
I gotta go and do something about this." It's going to be more persuasive. Let's say he's a video guy like you, shoot videos, and if he stands out on his home's neighborhood street and starts talking into a video camera saying, "I think that's what's terrible is going on up there in Chicago," that's not as persuasive as actually standing there in front of the guard tower or whatever,
saying, "Here it is,"
trying to go into the facility and having the bureaucrats say, "You're not allowed to be here," and making a video out of it that's a little bit more interesting to watch. I mean, everybody can put their opinion on YouTube. That's not hard to do. But being somewhere interesting, having interesting video footage to go along with that opinion could be the difference between it being viral and just being seen by a couple hundred people. That's not to say it's not worth doing. If all you can afford to do is stay home, you can still do something. But if you've got the ability, if somebody's going to give you a ride up there and you can pack a sandwich or whatever, and that's what's motivating you to you, go for it. I mean, you're not going to change the world likely with that one instance. You're not going to shut down the facility with your video probably, but it doesn't hurt, does it?
Point taken. I just hope to encourage people, if they won't have an emotional response to this story, to at least take some time to plan what you're doing. And if it's true that like this guy doesn't have a lot of money, well, at least have enough money to bring a camera.
And yes, for sure. You got to protect yourself. Absolutely. Chris Cantwell, you're on with us from Keene, New Hampshire.
Good to be with you, gentlemen. Hey. I heard you talking about the net neutrality thing. And as you're aware, I've been all over this story. And we had Kit Walsh from the Electronic Frontier Foundation on Free Talk Live. I later had Corinne McSherry on some garbage podcast. And I thought it was hilarious because these folks are billed as a libertarian website. They were like number two on toplibertarian.com. And they were pushing net neutrality. And I was rattling them. I'm like, "What are you doing? This is a terrible, terrible idea." And they kept on telling me about how, well, there's going to be this, they had this thing they called forbearance, that the FCC was going to, take the broadband providers under Title II, which is basically the regulations of the 1930s, but they were going to promise. They said, "Hey, we promise not to be too heavy-handed." And the EFF just thought that was a wonderful idea for some reason. And now I've got an article here on Electronic Frontier Foundation from February 24th, just before net neutrality passed. And basically they made this whole thing secret right before they did it, and then passed 300 pages of regulations.
Right. People could not read them unless you were in the FCC. You could not read the regulations prior to them passing.
Yeah, and it was hilarious. I'm watching the, you know, this lobbyist from the Electronic Frontier Foundation panic at the last minute, like, hey, wait a second. Oh, what are you doing? I thought that you guys were going to blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, it took you until 2015 to figure out that the government lies and screws people over? Is that really?
But you promised.
Hey, you're the ones protecting the internet?
So wait, what you're saying is EFF, they changed their tune at the last minute on this?
They didn't like the way they were doing it. They're not saying no net neutrality, but they were scared.
If there's more that you want to share, you can hang on and we can bring it back for that, because that's what Derek J. was telling me during one of the breaks. So well, sounds like you've gotten kind of the inside scoop here. 855-450-FREE. More coming up here on Free Talk Live.
Attention listeners, SurvivalLife.com is giving away free EverStrike permanent matches for a limited time only. These matches are waterproof and will light in any weather condition, rain, snow, or sleet. It will still throw a spark. Its built-in ferro rod strikes at 3,000 degrees, and it is good for 15,000 strikes. Normally, $15. Today, it's free. Get yours at FreeWaterproofMatch.com. Again, that's FreeWaterproofMatch.com. Hurry, supplies are limited. Visit FreeWaterproofMatch.com today.
This is Holly Thomas, Group Vice President of Cause Marketing for Macy's. Our company is working together with the March of Dimes through March for Babies to raise money and awareness about the serious problem of premature birth in the U.S. That's why Macy's is committed to raising funds through our employees, customers, family, and friends to improve the health of moms and babies everywhere. Won't you please join us in March for Babies? Start a team today at marchforbabies.org.
Hi, I'm Derek J. I don't want a politician to represent me. To me, government is the idea that one group of people can coerce everyone to comply with an edict or face increasing punishments up to and including death. Despite perhaps the most noble of intentions, the best government services are a far cry from what could be provided for by voluntary interactions. Besides, the people who call themselves the government wage wars and put peaceful people in jail for crimes involving no victims. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it. Use it. Spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Who did you let down today? Your wife? Your kids? Well, how about yourself? Take a look in the mirror. If you're tired of your drug and alcohol problem, you need to fix the problem and right now, before you hurt or kill yourself, or worse yet, somebody else. Call the addiction specialist now at the Detox and Treatment Helpline, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. If you have private insurance, we specialize in finding you the right treatment. When you call right now, you'll speak to a recovering addict who understands what you're going through right now. Let us help you break your addiction to drug and alcohol before it's too late. This call is completely confidential and free. So if you have private insurance, take 5 minutes of your time, call right now. I promise it'll change your life. 800-208-5187. 800-208-5187. 800-208-5187. Call right now. 800-208-5187.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
Back with more Free Talk Live, where we'll take your calls about anything you want to discuss. You just have to dial us toll-free at 855-450-FREE or send us a request on Skype. The username you'll need to send that request to is lrn.fm. Once you're approved, you can easily call us from that point forward using Skype, and then you'll sound pretty darn good, like Christopher Cantwell, who is one of the few people who cannot attend the upcoming New Hampshire Liberty Forum.
Womp, womp.
But, you know, Chris, you're back with us here. I would still love to see you there. I don't know if they can ban you from the entire hotel.
Yeah, you should come to the hotel.
But it would be great to have you come out. Either way, there are going to be a lot of Free Talk Live listeners who will be in attendance, and we've got a special offer where you can actually get you can get a free ticket, as a matter of fact. And you just have to meet three qualifications. One, you can't yet live in New Hampshire. You, two, cannot also yet be a Free State Project participant. And three, you have to commit to attend one session, specifically the FSP question session during the Liberty Forum. By the way, Liberty Forum is coming up this coming weekend, not this one that we're in right now, but the one following. So March 5th through the 8th. And so on Saturday the 7th, there's the FSP question session, which happens at 12:30, featuring Carla Mora, where she will field whatever questions people have about the Free State Project, the community here, what it's like to live in New Hampshire and be an activist here. All the questions you need to ask, or you can just sit there and watch. You don't have to ask a question. You just have to attend that session. If you're willing to do those three things, so you don't live in New Hampshire, or if you meet the three qualifications, you don't live in New Hampshire, you're not yet a Free State Project participant, and you're willing to attend that session, just email me, Ian@freetalklive.com. I'm told that this expires tomorrow, this offer, but if you get your email in, I can probably still get you the free ticket. So just email me and I'll get you hooked up. So again, that's nhlibertyforum.com. Free Talk Live will be broadcasting live from the event. I'll look forward to seeing a bunch of our listeners there. Chris Cantwell still with us here from ChristopherCantwell.com, talking about the Electronic Frontier Foundation. You had one of these guys on your show, Some Garbage Podcast, and the same lady you had on your show actually came out with some sort of statement upset about the FCC's decision. Is that right?
Yeah. Real quick before we get back into that, I just want to tell the listeners that Liberty Forum is a great event if you hate me. So just go to that. If you hate Christopher Cantwell, go get your ticket. It's free, of course. And I want to give a big rest in peace shout out to the Bad Quaker Podcast, who labeled me a government agent today and is now going off the airwaves. He's quitting, and I'm glad. Good riddance. Mm-hmm. Real quick. So I've got this message from Corinne McSherry on Electronic Frontier Foundation. I'll skip around and it really quick because I know that you guys probably have other callers and we're getting close to the end. She says, Dear FCC, rethink the vague, quote, general conduct rule. Our message has been clear from the beginning. The FCC has a role to play, but its role must be firmly bounded. 2 weeks ago, we learned that we had likely managed the first goal. The FCC is going to do the right thing and reclassify broadband as a telecommunications service, giving it the ability to make new, meaningful open internet rules. But we are deeply concerned that the FCC's new rules will include a provision that sounds like a recipe for overreach and confusion, the so-called general conduct rule. So,
surprise!
Right, they're saying that they're going to have like the arbitrary authority on a case-by-case basis to make whatever decisions they want about what, quote, harms consumers and edge providers, and this regulatory agency that's completely unelected, completely unaccountable,
yep,
is going to have the authority to arbitrarily decide what's good for the consumer and the edge provider. This is absolutely, it's the craziest thing in the world. And now she's all worried about it, that, hey, it sounds like you might be overreaching and we've spent all this money lobbying
to take over
the internet.
Yeah, they're overreaching now. And it's only been, what, 48 hours since they've signed this thing? I mean, the overreach began before the vote even happened. This should not be a surprise to anyone who's ever spent any time whatsoever observing how government works. I mean, even if they did create this program in the way the EFF wanted them to, which it sounds like they didn't, but even if they did put the rules into play initially that the EFF would have liked to have seen word for word, then it'll just end up going out of control later. You know, when other bureaucrats start administering the program and other, you know, different bureaucrats start interpreting these very same words in different ways. Over time, government programs grow beyond their original intentions and the unintended consequences become more and more vast and intense.
Yeah, one of the, she actually says right in this letter here, she says, what is worse, it could be abused by a future commission to target legitimate practices that offer significant benefits to the public. And I'm like, look, this is not a piece of legislation that you are trying to push through the Congress, right? This is handing the complete control of the internet over to the Federal Communications Commission, a regulatory agency. Mm-hmm. And then you're just telling us that this is a great idea because they're making promises to you that they're going to do things. Yeah. But of course, a regulatory agency, this is five guys, the FCC. They can do whatever they want once they have control over something. It's completely crazy. And like you said, I mean, we've had them on Free Talk Live. I've had them on some garbage podcast, and they just assured us that it was the greatest thing in the world. And of course, right before it passes, they start to realize, hey, wait a second, these guys are in the business of screwing people over.
So Chris, how are you going to tell these people I told you so?
I already did. I contacted Corinne on Twitter. She doesn't feel like responding to my tweet, apparently.
ChristopherCantwell.com. Thanks for the call tonight. Thanks, appreciate buddy. It. Let's go to David. He's in Florida listening to WYOO on FM. Hey, David.
Hey, guys. You know what? Ted Kennedy talked about this years ago, net neutrality.
Hmm.
And he mentioned it about having a free and open internet, and that we should not allow government control over this, more or less. That's what he was pushing for.
Hmm.
But over the last, you know, over the last couple of days, I've paid attention to this. And this is just something that, I'm sorry, people, the government wants to shut the internet down. They want to control the content.
Well, yeah, they're not going to shut the internet down because people would probably revolt in the same way that they would revolt if you turned off the cable television to Americans' homes. So as long as they can keep the information, as long as they can keep the entertainment flowing through the internet lines, people will be very, very happy. But they certainly want to be able to control, I think, the content at some point.
Right. They want to, you know, this government wants to control speech. It wants to control everything, either right, wrong, indifferent. It doesn't matter. Just like we've seen over in Egypt, we've seen it in Greece and stuff, where the internet has been completely shut off in the government. And what's happened, the people went completely ballistic and nuts and just rioted in the streets.
Yeah, but David, people will say that can't happen here. This is the United States. It's better than everywhere else.
Well, it will happen here. It does. It will happen because for the Second Amendment, the First Amendment guarantees our free speech. And this thing right here, I mean, can you say, open your mouth, stick your foot in it? Yeah, I think the EFF just did.
Thanks, David, for your call tonight. Let's talk to Dana in Grand Rapids, Michigan, listening to WTKG. Hello, Dana.
Hi to both of you.
Go ahead.
I called about the CIA black room, and my comment was going to be, and this is
it's actually the CPD strange. Black site. This isn't CIA. Oh, this is Chicago Police.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean that. I got.
But it's
CIA
essentially the same thing. I mean, it's the same concept.
Right. It's on a local. It's more local level.
Right.
You know. You've got your federal, your state, your municipality. But my comment to you guys, I cannot believe you brought this Chris guy on. I'm so glad. In fact, I meant to call you last Saturday to talk to the people. Not that it would have mattered because they had a petition going around that you could sign online, but this was going to go through anyway, this vote on Thursday.
Oh, yeah.
And the reason why I called tonight was because my statement to you guys and to the audience was going to be, still is, that I cannot believe you guys are surprised about this secret room when there was one of these commissioners. There's three, it's a board of five. Three right now under Obama are Democrat, two are Republican. There are appointed positions by the current president. One of the two Republicans is named Ajit Pai. He had a website he put up, and he went on multiple talk shows. Unfortunately, they were mostly conservative. And he was warning people at least three weeks ago is the time I first heard it.
Yeah.
He said, and he's getting in trouble now. Obama's
Yeah, he was warning people that this net neutrality vote essentially gives the FCC total control over all aspects of the internet. Thank you, Dana. More coming up here on Free Talk Live.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges. Yeah! This is Davi Barker from ShinyBadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at ShinyBadges.com, write WORMS in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
By now, you may have heard a bit about Bitcoins, but did you know Bitcoins are now over an $8.5 billion market? And did you know that over 65,000 businesses now accept Bitcoins? Listen, if you're already earning Bitcoins or trying to make money in the Bitcoin market, you've got to know BidBit.co. Why? Because BidBit.co is where you can easily receive Bitcoin by selling and auctioning off your own personal items or promote business products and services for Bitcoins. You heard right. Whether personal or business, you can now buy, sell, and auction your product and services quickly, easily, and securely for Bitcoin at BidBit.co, the first and only marketplace website to offer BidBit escrow, a proprietary technology which gives buyers and sellers security and peace of mind because all transactions are protected. Start today. It's free to join, free to post, free to auction, and free to bid at BidBit.co. Buy, sell, bid, or auction everything Bitcoin. That's www.bidbit.co. BidBit.co.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial on in toll-free here. In the remaining moments, we've got enough time to sneak in. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. 855-450-3733. We have also some time to tell you a little bit more about the black site, as it has been described in Chicago. Black because it's sort of off the books. It doesn't really officially exist. I mean, it's been acknowledged that it by Chicago police that the place exists, but you can't just go and take a tour of it. It's not some kind of open facility in any way, shape, or form. In fact, attorneys cannot even find their clients a lot of the time when they're there. If you've been arrested in Chicago, there's a chance you'll get taken to this black site, as it is described, where people have been tortured They have been shackled and cuffed for hours on end, one man for 17 hours straight. Others as long as being held there for as long as 24 hours without being allowed to see an attorney, being questioned without being read Miranda rights, which of course was a famous Supreme Court case that said that the police have to read you these rights to inform you that you have the right to remain silent if they're going to be questioning you about the case. And so there's a little bit more here. In fact, Derek Jay, there was an experience that you wanted to share with us from one of the prisoners there.
Yes,
detainees, if you will.
Right. One of the men, whose name is Hutcherson, says he was punched in the face while in this position, the one
chained
where
up.
His arms were chained to opposite sides of his body, before an officer stepped on his groin.
Ugh.
Like he was putting out a cigarette. That's a quote. Another lawyer told The Guardian that in early 2014, police told him that his client, another young black man, was not at Homan Square, even though he was. So it's not only that they're just not telling them, oh, we don't know if they're here. It's no, he's not here, and he was. So what the prison put out about, lawyers and doctors and anyone who needs to contact the prisoners
come
here.
Come on in!
Yeah, of course they can communicate just like any other facility, but that's not true. And what also was quoted about the subject of torture, while Terry, this is another detainee, said that he didn't see anyone else confined at Homan in 2011. Just a minute. Think about how creepy that is, being at a facility where you're chained up somewhere and you don't even see any other prisoners.
Except for the guards. Yeah, you see some guards and that's it. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I would think I might have been flown to another country where they are going to torture me. Well,
scary.
He said he heard people yelling, no, 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 and stop. He remembered seeing chain link cages, like what we were describing earlier,
right,
of the sort previously described by The Guardian, by attorneys and former police superintendent. They reminded him of dog kennels, he said. Quote, they've got kennels, like, for people. I didn't really want to believe that, but it's the truth.
More from the another Guardian.com story on this. The raid of the folks that were called the NATO 3 did attract a lot of attention, and they were taken, all of the 11 people during that raid were taken to this facility, this black site. After 12 hours of active searching, they could not find, the attorneys could not find their clients. Only after they made a major stink with various different contacts within the government did they learn about the existence of this place. They sent another attorney to the facility, where he ultimately did gain entry and talked to the church through a floor-to-ceiling chain link metal, excuse me, to church, that's Brian Jacob Church, talked to church through a floor to ceiling chain link metal cage, which is what you were just describing. Finally, hours later, police took Church and his two co-defendants to a nearby police station for booking. After serving 2.5 years in prison, Church is currently on parole after he and his co-defendants were found not guilty in 2014 of terrorism-related offenses, but guilty of lesser charges of possessing an incendiary device and the misdemeanor of mob action. The access that NATO 3 attorneys received to Homan Square was an exception to the rule, even if Jacob Church's experience there was not. Three attorneys interviewed by The Guardian report being personally turned away from Homan Square between 2009 and 2013 without being allowed to access their clients. Two more lawyers who hadn't been physically denied described it as a place where police withheld information about their clients' whereabouts. Church was the only person who had been detained at the facility who agreed to talk with The Guardian. Their lawyers say others fear police retaliation. Now, this was the older article. This is the first article that came out. Yours came out, I think, a few
days after.
So maybe some people are being emboldened by this and now coming out and speaking.
Yeah, they're like, I was at this place too. By the way, how would you like to be the company that produces these chain link cages for the prison? I mean, this is not their finest moment. Like, I could imagine being surprised if I were the CEO. Like, wait, you used it for what? You like, maybe they weren't intending this for humans.
One man in January 2013 had his name changed in the Chicago Central Bookings database and then taken to Homan Square without record of his transfer being kept. According to Eliza Solowij of the Chicago First Defense Legal Aid. She found out where he was after he was taken to the hospital with a head injury. So they changed his name in the system. They then moved him out of the the sort of on the books place, the holding facility that he was at, took him to Homan Square, disappeared him for a while, and then he showed up at a hospital with a head injury. Quote, he said the officers caused his head injuries in an interrogation room at Homan Square. I had been looking for him for 6 to 8 hours, and every department member I talked to said they'd never heard of him. He sent me a phone picture of his head injuries because I had seen him in a police station right before he was transferred to Homan Square without any injuries. Bartmiss, another Chicago attorney, said that in September of 2013, she got a call from a mother worried that her 15-year-old son had been picked up by police before dawn. A sympathetic sergeant followed up with the mother to say her son was being questioned at Homan Square.
Oh my God.
In connection to a shooting and would be released soon. When hours passed, Bartmiss traveled to Homan Square only to be refused entry for nearly an hour. An officer told her at the time, quote, well, you can't just stand here taking notes. This is a secure facility. There are undercover officers, and you're making people very nervous. Bartmiss recalled.
You're making people nervous, yeah. Lady? Standing here taking notes? Yeah, you've got a secret prison you're standing in front of, sir.
Told to leave, she said she would return in an hour if the boy was not released. He was home and not charged after maybe 12 or 13 hours in custody. Let's go to your calls here. Nathan is on the line on Skype in Texas. Go ahead, Nathan.
Hey, guys. You brought up the net neutrality thing, and also I wanted to respond to Chris Cantwell real quick. It is sad that the Bad Quaker podcast has or is coming to an end, but I would suggest if Cantwell checks out episode 158, then he might have known who the middle guy on the Bad Quaker website is. So
that's a little obscure.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Well, he gets what I'm talking about.
If you want to talk to Chris Cantwell, you should email him directly. This, you know, calling Free Talk Live for a little messenger service action is probably not the best use of airtime. So your other point.
Well, I was curious if you guys had any stories about bad customer service from either government-like organizations or, you know, industries where there's not a lot of competition.
Everyone has bad customer service stories from government. So, yeah, I mean, of course. Who doesn't have that? Oh, he just hung up his phone or his Skype. The less competition an industry has, the worse the service is going to be. I mean, all you have to do is look to the cable companies, to the phone companies. When I say phone companies, I mean, the landline phone operators that essentially have a monopoly over a certain geographic area. The power company is always a good one.
I think just to answer Nathan's question about bad government service stories, I think the worst one that comes to mind is the post office in Philadelphia. When I lived there, there was a huge post office. It must have been the first one. I mean, I know that one of the first post offices in the country is in Philadelphia, right, where Ben Franklin started his. But down the street, there's another big one that has got Gothic architecture. It's beautiful. It looks like at one time it was sort of the Dagny Taggart, Atlas Shrugged style huge facilities that could service millions of people. But today, they keep 3 windows open out of 100.
Wow.
And they keep you waiting down a long line all throughout the building. And
what?
You have to wait through the whole thing just to get stamps, to
ridiculous.
Send a package, send a letter. It's totally ridiculous. And it's not like the people are friendly once you get to them at the end of waiting, sometimes over an hour in
at
this
line. At
least
here in Keene, sometimes they're friendly. I mean, I haven't gone to the post office very often, but the few times I have, I've actually been kind of pleased at how decent the bureaucrats are here.
Well, I just think about what kind of a service has been around for hundreds of years, you know, has
and can treat people like
competition
that.
Yeah, denied competition to Lysander Spooner in the 1800s, and then today still treats people like that in 2015. It's crazy.
Well, they don't. I mean, even though they have competition in shipping packages from FedEx, DHL, UPS, they don't have competition still in the dollar or less, the what's called the first class mail category, and that's what they went after Lysander Spooner for. They still have the monopoly in that area. You cannot send mail for less than a dollar using anything but the postal service. If you try operating in competition with them, they will have you arrested for it. We're out of time tonight, but you can join Derek J on his website at derekj.me and join more Free Talk Live online at freetalklive.com. See you tomorrow. On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day.
from wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of Liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Off the Air Live is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Friday, February 27th, 2015. Gold is trading at $1,210, silver at $16.59, and Bitcoin is trading around $251.47. Today's Bitcoin price brought to you by ExpressCoin, the fastest and most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at ExpressCoin.com. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from the Texas Bitcoin Conference, March 28th and 29th at ACL Live at the Moody Theater. Join scores of Bitcoin experts and enthusiasts from around the world for talks, networking, and a $1 million Bitcoin 2.0 hackathon. Tickets on sale now at TexasBitcoinConference.com. In the news, the Washington Times calls it a landmark decision. That follows Thursday's FCC approval of net neutrality, which gives the federal government a major role in oversight of internet traffic. Critics decry the move as a gateway into government oversight of the entire internet. The Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, commonly known as DARPA, is close to completing an advanced voice recognition program. The agency is in the third phase of the Robust Automatic Transcription of Speech, RATS program, which is capable of deciphering human voices even when background noise renders the conversation inaudible. In honor of the launch of the new and improved SovereignLiving.com, each day this week, the Liberty Beat is bringing you a simple survival tip that just might save your life. With today's tip, here's John Bush.
Have a bug-out plan. You never know when a crisis could occur. Some disasters could be so severe that you and your family need to leave your home immediately. It's important that you have a plan as to where you are going to go should you need to vacate your home. Also, if your family or bug-out group members are not in the same place when your crew decides it's time to get the heck out of Dodge, it's important to have a predetermined meeting place so everyone is on the same page and knows where to go. Make sure your plan takes into account what the environment might be like in a disaster or civil unrest scenario. What will major roads be like? Could bridges be down? Could checkpoints be set up? Pre-stock your bug-out location with enough supplies to last you and your crew a month or longer should you need to hunker down for the long haul. Finally, keep your bug-out plan on a need-to-know basis. You don't want the authorities or your neighbor Bob showing up unexpectedly.
Today's broadcast of the Liberty Beat is brought to you by CoinArch, offering innovative online trading solutions for Bitcoin. Visit CoinArch.com and sign up using coupon.